say both of those words together because of actual trademark things, but we're here. My parents are here,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, live studio audience.
We
Hi,
have a
guys.
Live studio audience. This is awesome. My parents are here for the weekend. It was my mom's birthday yesterday, so happy birthday to mom. Just want to say that real quick. Another anniversary of her 29th. That is how we celebrate
That's true. Darn straight. Love it. Welcome in. So I see you have a coffee in front of you.
Yes, I
heard the coffee
caffeine.
Shop delayed you. Is that what happened here?
Well, I don't know. It was a little bit of a fumble on my part. Tried to order online on the app. We did that. Mom's order came in. We were wondering what the heck was happening, and it turns out I accidentally hit the drive-thru option instead of the pickup counter. So the mother's intuition, I'll give you this. I'll give you the shout-out. She said, hey, why don't you go up and ask? And I'm like, okay, let's see what happens. They're probably just delayed. And it turns out, hey, shout out to mom. You were right. I made a mistake.
Okay, now I'm gonna get very in the weeds for a moment.
Let's do it. Why not?
If you order a coffee.
This isn't even about basketball anymore. This is just grilling my life.
Yeah, probably.
That's what it is.
We'll get basketball. We're on until 10:40. We'll get the basketball around 10:35. We're going to grill your life in the meantime.
Yeah, that sounds good.
So you order this. Through, I'm confused. So you walk in, the drive-through line and the counter aren't that far apart. Why don't they know this?
Yeah.
So you walk in, you say, hey, this is an order for Pablo, right?
Yes.
And they're we have one coffee?
In this situation, no, I didn't. Okay. But, yeah, typically, so it's, you know, it's ordering online. You put the order through the app, and it's the fast pass way to get your coffee sooner instead of walking into the store, putting in the order. Like, the order's hopefully ready for you by that point. So in the Starbucks app, at least, there's two different options where you can choose the pickup from the counter or the drive-thru option. So, yeah, again, that's where things just got a little messy from there.
Okay, I follow. Well, I'm glad you're here nonetheless.
I'm here. We made it.
Hair looks good.
Thank you. I did this for you, too. I knew I was going to be on radio, so I had to make sure.
You had to be handsome.
I had to make just for you. I just wanted to impress you, Alex.
Breaking news. We are streaming live on Twitter and YouTube. So,
hello.
You are on camera. I know that's something you're used to. I'm not. I wore a red shirt underneath a blue hoodie. That's where I'm at.
Hey, you're
today.
Looking good. You're
I don't know
good.
About that, but I'll take the compliment.
I just want to acknowledge, too, that...
Yeah.
I know you are very much an early riser, too.
Yeah, that's me. That's my
thing.
You're
a morning guy.
Yeah.
I know you. So it's I know this is just totally normal to be up at this hour for you.
I feel like...
It's not.
Yeah, no, you're right. I feel like... I think anybody that's heard me before knows I'm typically asleep right now.
Yes.
Yeah. I got home around midnight after the WIA state tournament last night, which, by the way, there was a 4-overtime game last night that I was in attendance for. That was the most bonkers thing I've ever seen in my entire life.
I thought, so I was there for the Thursday games. I was there for the Lakeside Lutheran buzzer beater and the Mineral Point 8-point comeback in 25 seconds. I thought those two games were insane. And then I hear triple overtime, quadruple overtime. Maybe we could talk about this, an alternative to when we get to X amount of overtimes, what is the tiebreaker versus just keep going into overtime periods? You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah, I mean, it sucks that, especially at the high school level.
But, yeah.
but it does suck that somebody had to lose.
Yes.
Because you're in 4 overtimes. And, you know, obviously, as high school kids, somebody is in their senior season. Somebody is playing their last basketball game last night.
Basically two.
Right.
Well, I don't know what how long are the overtime periods?
4 minutes. So they played 16 extra minutes, which is essentially an extra half.
Okay, there you go.
But with all the timeouts and the pauses between overtimes, I mean, it was an extra hour essentially. So I feel bad for Arrowhead, who ended up beating Mina in that game. They play in a state championship today.
That's gonna.
I don't know how their legs are feeling, but nonetheless, I mean, it was absolutely the most bonkers basketball game I've ever seen at any level last night at the Kohl Center. Electric atmosphere. Good atmosphere at the Kohl Center for state basketball,
yeah.
Which is going on this weekend.
Well, you know, it's crazy. This is actually the first time I'm attending in person. Because it's on our, it's televised on our air, we're in different spots because usually this weekend is a lot more crazier, whether it's Big Ten or it's March Madness first weekend. So it gets a little chaotic. And we usually have people at WIAA calling the play-by-play. We have, you know, somebody else here. So we're kind of trying to cover a bunch of different things. So I typically relied on the broadcast in years past, and then somebody would send us the sound from the press conference room. This year is completely different for me, actually being there in person. I love the state atmospheres, especially basketball, too. There's something about it. It's just a fun, electric atmosphere to be at the Kohl Center and get to experience these things.
So how many years have you been in Madison now?
We're coming up on 3 years in about a couple weeks.
Okay. Yeah. So you and I, that's right, you and I started here about the same time.
Yep.
So this is the first one of the 3 years.
Yes.
Right, because this is the first year that the NCAA tournament hasn't overlapped. Okay, I gotcha. Yeah. Interesting. I mean, it's a really cool atmosphere, and it seems like attendance is back up this year. And obviously, when you have a 4-overtime game, you're gonna turn some eyeballs. So, are you off today with the parents in town?
No, we're grinding left and right. We are going straight to the Kohl Center for these for the first three games because our area, who we cover, we have a team playing for a state championship in the first three games, but. Just 5, 4, and 3. Those are the games that we have.
So you're rushing out of here to get over to the Kohl Center. Are your parents credentialed members of the media this weekend?
They are not, but they are my certified Uber drivers. Because it's also the other crazy thing is that we don't have parking passes. So right. there's a little bit of a situation there, but we don't have parking passes. So if anything, they're actually doing me a solid and just dropping me off, versus me trying to find a parking spot in one of those garages. Waiting for the lines to just clear out, so they're doing me a solid. They're going to drop me off at the Kohl Center and then come pick me up after.
I love how nice you're being because they're sitting right next to you.
Yeah.
However, I'm going to be mean to you while your parents are in attendance.
I feel like
there's no better way to say happy birthday, Mom, than saying, hey, come to work with me.
Hey, come on by.
Mom, let's put you to work. Happy birthday.
Come on by. I told my dad I might bring him on. I might bring my mom on, too. Why not? Why not?
What time are you on tonight?
I'm just behind the scenes. So Luke and I are switching spots. So he'll be
Luke Gamble.
Luke Gamble. So he'll be anchoring the 6 and 10. Last week he did what I'm doing today in Green Bay. So shooting all the games, taking care of posts, and then sending it back for our show.
So you didn't need to do your hair today.
I just did it. You know, again, I just did it for you. I just wanted to impress you and our live stream viewers.
Indeed. Riley Auk is running the show for us today here at the Everlight Solar Studio in downtown Madison. Riley, good morning. Your hair looks terrific, too. You have a mullet for anybody that can't see you.
Thank you.
It's slicked back today.
Yeah. See, here's the thing. It's slicked back every single day because I wet my hair and then I comb it.
Wow, okay.
It's so smooth. It looks really smooth. I like
you.
It.
I appreciate that. You have really nice hair, so that means a lot.
Good jeans. They're right here, too. So.
Yeah, your dad also with the slick back. Looking good. But yeah, so when it dries out, it becomes less smooth and less slick, and then it kind of gets all over the place.
Very good. I'm glad we're all getting to know each other. Yeah. Riley and Pablo, I assume this is the first time you've met.
Yeah, this is the first time. Well, actually, we're best friends.
Through the glass.
And you're best friends because you like each other's hair.
Yes.
We're just making connections this morning on Saturday tip-off. we'll take a break. When we come back, we're going to talk Wisconsin Badgers, who are in the semifinals of the Big Ten tournament after another win yesterday over Northwestern. They'll take on Purdue for the third time this season later today. It's a noon tip-off on CBS. The winner of that game obviously going to tomorrow's Big Ten championship game. Can the Badgers finally knock down Zach Edey and the Purdue Boilermakers? We talk about that next. It's Saturday Tip-Off right here on ESPN Madison.
This is Saturday Tip-Off on ESPN Wisconsin and Wisconsin On Demand.
Greg Scalzo here for Buck and Honey's. Congratulations to the perennial Best of Madison Award winner by the folks at Madison Magazine. Meet me at Buck and Honey's to celebrate Wisconsin hospitality. Whether you're enjoying the view on the Yahara River in Monona, exploring Wanakee, visiting the OG in Sun Prairie, or checking out the new location in Mount Horeb, you can enjoy the Buck and Honey's experience in a neighborhood near you. Serving lunch and dinner 7 days a week with brunch every Saturday and Sunday, I'll see you at Buck and Honey's.
To those who've ever dreamt of their perfect event, those dreams are worthy and they are possible. Hi, it's Jeffrey from Celebrations Entertainment. With hard work, passion, and great music, we will make your event dreams a reality. Every event is a labor of love, with one-on-one planning, customization, and flawless execution. Bringing your event to life is what we do. For a fun, memorable event, visit celebrationsentertainment.com. That's celebrationsentertainment.com.
At Gruber Losses, we take great pride in helping those who have trusted us after a serious accident. Our team has the knowledge, resources, and experience to get you the results you deserve. Don't wait to get the help you need. Make the right call. Call Gruber Law Offices today. Proud partner of Wisconsin Athletics. One call, that's all.
Hey, it's Bobby Portis, and I love playing basketball in Milwaukee. When I drive down the lane, I move fast and make sudden moves to drive to the hoop and score. But when I'm behind the wheel in the driving lane, I control my drive. I don't speed or make sudden movements. Speeding and reckless driving are the leading causes of traffic injuries and deaths in Wisconsin. Do what I do. Control your drive. Don't speed. Don't be reckless. Zero in, Wisconsin. Together we can save lives. Wisconsin DOT.
From the biggest plays on the court to the comments made in the locker room after, an in-depth recap of every Bucks game in 6 minutes. No more, no less. Bucks in 6 provides game recaps for every game. Hear the high-flying dunks from Giannis.
Puts it on the floor, spins down the lane, and plunges it through.
Or the deep threes from Dame.
Dame time has arrived with 107.
Bucks in 6 on the Bucks Plus Audio Network. Find it now on bucks.com/plus or on Spotify, Apple, and wherever you get your podcasts.
I love playing sports, especially for my school. And that's because school sports are special. It's where it's safe to fail. It's where we're taught resilience, where our fear becomes confidence. It's where we learn to get back up after every fall. School sports are where 7.8 million students go from I can't to I can.
This message presented by the WIAA and the Wisconsin Athletic Directors Association.
Life's better with American Family Insurance because our home policies help protect your dreams and come with peace of mind. Save up to 25% by bundling home, auto, and life. American Family Insurance. Get a quote, find an agent at amfam.com.
Products not available in every state. Discounts may not apply to all coverages on an auto or home policy. Discounts do not apply to life insurance policies. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating companies, American Family Life Insurance Company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
Good Karma Brands is proud to be an equal opportunity employer. Our policy is to provide equal opportunity employment, development, and advancement to all current and potential teammates. If you are an organization that maintains a job bank, provides employment information, or gives job referrals, you may request to be placed on the station's mailing list for future career opportunities. To learn more about careers at Good Karma Brands, please email careers@goodkarmabrands.com.
From the preps,
Russell spins his way into the paint with contact, finishes, and a foul.
That was pretty.
To the pros,
Beverly launches from three, and he knocks it down.
The biggest games play on 100.5 ESPN.
The dog days are over. The dog days are done. The horses are coming, so you.
Tip-off on your Saturday morning, 9:14 a.m. at the Everlight Solar Studio, downtown Madison. Alex Strofe alongside my good friend Pablo Iglesias at WKOW with me.
I thought you were dishing it off to me to say my name, which I was up for.
Okay,
which,
let's try it again. I'm Alex Strofe.
And I'm Pablo Iglesias.
You're good at that, though, because you do that on TV, right?
Do I?
I'm Pablo Iglesias with sports.
I do.
We'll be back after this.
Yeah, that's it.
How'd I do?
You did great.
Okay.
I was wondering, I'm like, are we going to go to break? Wow, that was a quick one.
So I got my ego inflated, which happens quite often, might I add, right? I have a very large ego, as you know about me. I was talking to our mutual friend Jocko of NBC 15, and he said to me something you've never said to me.
Oh, boy.
Yesterday, and he goes, Strofe, we got to get you on TV.
What?
Yeah, and I was like, why?
Oh, no, I would say the same thing.
What would I do on TV, Pablo?
You could be like me and just, you always talk about how I just have these random hand gestures. You can do that with me.
Oh, wait. Can I just stand next to you? Don't mic me up. I'll just wear a scrappy outfit, which will make you look better because you'll be wearing a tie. Right? Like, I'll wear a hoodie and some jeans, right? I'll just look. But I'll play the wacky inflatable tube man you see at car dealerships. I feel like I could pull that off pretty well. That could be my role.
Spit take right there. I shouldn't have done that.
I think that would make for good TV.
I'm up for it.
But I'm not a TV guy, right?
I'll pitch it.
I'm very good. I'm very good at hiding my face, as they say, a face for radio. So, anyway, we're with you. We're with you until about 10:45 today, leading you up to state basketball coverage. Zimmer Conda's presentation of Prep Mania, which kicks off at 10:45 a.m. This score in double figures, the Badgers lose.
Here is my thing, too. Of course, you want your starting lineup to play. I mean, it's obviously it. You know, I'm not really going on a limb and saying, you know, everybody's got to be playing their best basketball this season. Of course,
that's fair.
But
yep.
I see the missing links in terms of Kamari McGee and John Blackwell being healthy and what that provides for this team. I'm not saying that Kamari McGee is going to come off and give. I mean, honestly, his return was pretty electric.
It sure was.
I think he had 10 points. It was either one or the other. I'll go back and look at this. It was either 10 points in 11 minutes or 11 points in 10 minutes of play, which is just absolutely insane. He even said it in postgame that he was just feeling
11 and 10.
11 and 10. We got the correction there. Ding, ding, ding. Thank you. But there it is. All right. We're ready to go. Thank you, Riley. But I really like the spark that Kamari McGee brings off that bench. Also, just because it gives guys rest. I mean, that's the obvious thing there, too. Who knows exactly what that slide was like for this last month and a half for these Badgers? It wasn't a pretty thing to watch by any means. But when you get a healthy John Blackwell, you get a good Kamari McGee, you get those guys coming off the bench, and then your starters are fresh. I'd love to see Max Klusman start to turn it up into the level that we saw him at the beginning of the season, because he was just unreal, especially from downtown.
Totally. I mean, it seems like, especially with Klusman, some games he'll just be terrific. Some games he'll just be Klusman, right?
Right,
but,
right.
But he's had a few games, maybe four this season, where he's legitimately saved the Badgers from losing.
Yes.
That Marquette game being probably the most notable early on in the season, where he had like 24 points in the first half or something absurd. And it's just funny to see how guys on this team can just pop off and then, but not be consistently a scoring threat, if you will. So
yeah, and that was the interesting thing that when I was talking to Greg Gard, kind of at the halfway of the season, was asking, how do you feel about this team? Where do you guys stand in as one of the top in the country, especially when they were at six at the point? And he was always pointing to their depth, but at the same point saying that their depth is almost a blessing and a curse. And I don't want to say that we saw the terrible, terrible side. But we did see what happened when, you know, you know what happens when you always say, like, a championship team needs a little bit of luck, too. You need to stay healthy. You need to build a bit of that luck. And they got a little tested when those injuries went down. Of course, it wasn't just starters. It was still two guys who had pretty decent minutes who were key role players. And, yeah, I think the fact that they're coming back at the right time and they're playing pretty good basketball at this time, that's a good situation for the Badgers.
I'm right there with you. Pablo Iglesias, at Pablo Iglesias TV on Twitter. I'm Alex Strofe. You can get me on Twitter at Alex_Strofe, STROUF. Twitter X, what do you call it? Do you still refer to it as Twitter?
I think so, yeah. It just feels weird to call it X. Follow me on X.
Wow.
Yeah, I would agree. It's I feel like that's one of the worst rebrands in the history of American culture.
It just feels like a social experiment, to be honest.
Yeah,
that's just what it feels like.
That's a fair point. Nonetheless,
social media experiment. Am I right? Ha! All right.
Where's the cricket? Where's the cricket hotkey, Riley? That would be a good time for that.
Not sure exactly. Too late. We've already celebrated it.
Yeah, we've already celebrated it. You're a genius. Excuse me. You're like the new Chris Farley in the Madison area. That's what that was.
Cool.
Looking at this Badgers team and the way they've turned it around. I mean, going back to January, this was viewed as a team that could make the Final Four. This was viewed as a top 10 team in the country. And then they go into February, and I think they posted a record of something like 2-7 or 2-8 in the month of February, and only a couple wins here in the month of March. But they go into the Big Ten tournament. They get that huge win over Maryland the other day, and then a come-from-behind win against Northwestern yesterday. I just don't know that this offense can be consistent enough to be a real threat come next week. Obviously, the bracket coming out tomorrow.
This just the way that I view March, especially these last few years, it just gets weird. And I mean today I think is going to be a very interesting test to see.
Agreed.
Do I think wholeheartedly 100% that they can go in there and beat Purdue? I don't know, 100%. I think there's a chance, obviously, because like I said, March is just a weird time of the year. But well, here's the other thing. It's hard to beat a team three times in a year. So we'll see. We will see, because it's not like, you know, it was interesting watching the Badgers play against Purdue at home. I actually thought that they were going to come back in the second half, but It even seemed like, too, even after that loss when they played last Sunday or this past Sunday, the Badgers actually felt pretty good. They felt decent. Even though they, you know, nobody likes to lose, they felt better about this loss. Because, I mean, there were situations where at Mackey Arena, which is a tough situation, I mean, now you're on a neutral site today.
Mm-hmm.
Who knows what happens from there? They brought them within four on their home or on Purdue's home court. I like that fight in the Badgers. And this feels like more of a little closer to that, you know, ranked team that we saw earlier in the season. Do I think that they're the exact same team? Unfortunately not right now. But we saw a little bit of the sprinklings of that team that, you know, we saw in the top 25, I think, to an extent at that Purdue game.
I would agree. I think the last week and a half or so, they've turned it around since that win over Rutgers in the home finale. And obviously, that's transitioned here into the Big Ten tournament over the course of the last two games. They're in the semifinals today, taking on the third-ranked team in the country, the Purdue Boilermakers, like I mentioned, at the 12 o'clock tip on CBS. A.J. Storr coming off a 30-point game. Stephen Crowell, as mentioned, scored 19 points yesterday. Tyler Wall, kind of non-existent. 0 points, 0 for 4 from the field for him yesterday. But off the bench, Marcus Ilver getting minutes all of a sudden, Pablo?
I like it.
Extensive minutes? I do too.
I like it. You know, he's a guy that this felt like very Chris Collinsworth on that intro. But
here's a guy.
Here's a guy. Now, Marcus Ilver, though, I know that they've wanted to build his confidence. And he wanted to make a jump this year, and you've seen it in minutes. And just looking at the box score yesterday, 16 minutes again, I really like it. I mean, were there some opportunities that he could have cashed in on against Purdue? Absolutely. But you know what? It's a very intense environment for a guy who's still trying to find his footing. But I can see a little bit of those small leaps that he's made from last year compared to this year. So it's really cool. It gives you length. He's a good shooter. And when he heats up, he could be somebody that you look out for or got to look out for.
I like that take from Pablo Iglesias on Marcus Ilver, who played 16 minutes yesterday in the win over Northwestern. Tyler Wall only played 24 minutes, the lowest of any starter. But should be mentioned, a guy by the name of John Blackwell made his way into the starting lineup yesterday. No Chucky Hepburn yesterday for the Badgers. So John Blackwell getting the start, played 24 minutes as well, only scored 3 points. He's better off the bench. Some people just are. I don't know why. Why are some people just better? Like Lou Williams, for example, in the NBA. He won like every Sixth Man of the Year award, it felt like, for a decade in the NBA. Why are some people just better off the bench, Pablo? I was not a world-class athlete, so I have no idea.
Well, this first off, I have to call you out on that one because we had this little debate back and forth. Weren't we talking about just playing a one-on-one basketball game?
Oh, I'd smoke you, yeah.
Oh, okay, but oh, you'd smoke me, but you're not a world-class athlete. I don't know.
What that says about you.
But. Oh man. All right. Well, I think we just need to settle this now. We need to take a break, and we need to just play one-on-one basketball real quick.
We do have a Papa Shot machine. I don't know if we can play a good version of one-on-one on that, but we do have a Papa Shot machine
feels,
here.
This feels like I don't know. I'd have to figure that out. There might be some home advantage. You might be fixing that rim just so it falls for your shots and not mine. I don't know. I'm calling you out on this one.
I do have a magnet in one of those basketballs, but that's neither here nor there.
We were talking about bench players.
We
right?
were, yeah. Why do some people play better off the bench? What's the psychology there? I don't get it.
You know, that's a good question. I forgot. There was a player that I recently heard. I don't know if I was listening to a podcast or something about that, where they were a role player their entire career and almost said they enjoyed that more so versus then being like the star or the starter, because then it's almost a harder job too. Because then you have to readjust, you have to kind of figure out the chemistry, but you also get to watch the game from afar. Like, you get to see what's happening, you get to watch the defense, you get to see how the offense is moving, and then you insert yourself. I mean, it's a little harder than just plug and play, but you get to scout things out a little bit outside of just the opening tip, and then you get to watch a little bit of the game, and then when it's your time to go in, then you can say, hey, such and such is hot from the field. I'm seeing them going off the pick and roll, all those types of things. So you get a little bit of a scouting report before you go into the game. That's just my take, and I cannot remember for the life of me who said that, but it was a really interesting take, and I never thought about it.
I would have never thought about it this way. I'm just going to give you credit. This is your journalistic background coming through.
That's me. A big, big six man. Well, I thought it was going to be coming off the bench. I didn't think I was going to be ready for opening tip for this show, so I had to scout it out and just see what the landscape was like and then just jump in.
Now, literally, I cracked the mic and I saw you walk in. I mean, it worked out perfectly. Hey. You weren't late at all. You were on the floor for the opening tip, in my opinion. You made it, indeed. Saturday tip-off, a special Saturday morning show leading you up to our state coverage of Zimbraconda's presentation of Prep Mania. You can hear all five WIAA boys basketball state championship games today right here on 100.5 ESPN. And if you're driving north, you can also catch them on 1430 ESPN Beaver Dam and, of course, on the Wisconsin On Demand app and however you listen, the ESPN app to ESPN Madison and ESPN Beaver Dam. All five state championship games beginning with our coverage about an hour and 15 from right now, 10:45 this morning from the Kohl Center in downtown Madison. Jesse Nelson and Adam Mertz will kick off your coverage. I'll be with you for the Division II state championship game between Pewaukee and Wisconsin Lutheran a little bit later today. Riley, how much work are you putting in on this Saturday? Do you have to produce a couple of games coming up later? What's your day look like?
Yeah, so I'm producing this show, obviously, which isn't too bad. I just hit a few sound effects.
What do you mean isn't too bad? You should say this is a darn privilege, Riley.
Don't let him bully you. I'm here for this.
Thank you, Pablo. Yeah. I appreciate that.
I don't know what's going on with you two. I don't like this little bromance that's sparking up between the two of you, calling each other's hair pretty.
I always protect everybody in the booth. I feel like the booth, you know, everybody, they always just get to mess with people in the booth. So, no, I'm here for you. I was an intern back in the booth back in the day, man.
He understands the grind.
Okay, but Riley, so do I, right? Because Pablo has filled in on this station many times, and the majority of the times Pablo has filled in on the station, I was sitting where you're sitting.
Hmm.
Right?
I see. So,
did you always protect me when I was back there? Because I don't think you did.
Didn't I? I thought I did.
I feel like you and Rutledge beat up on me together as Bears fans because I was outnumbered as a Packers fan.
Whoa, Pablo, you're a Bears fan?
Oh, yeah. Come on.
I'm killing this
romance. Let's go, man. You know what? Who needs an offensive line when we've got quarterback question mark with all those offensive weapons? I am excited for that.
I know this show is called Saturday Tip Off, which indicates we're going to talk about basketball.
Yeah, here we go.
But I actually do have questions for a Bears fan, and I want to do that. Coming up
next,
they trade for Keenan Allen from the Los Angeles. I do legitimately have questions. I'm going to be respectful about it because I'm very curious what's going on in Chicago. I like to have respectful conversations, Pablo.
See, yeah, that's the thing. It's just like saying no offense or like respectfully. You know, it's like, hey, no offense, but Alex, you smell a little funny today.
Okay, well, I'll get it out now and then we'll be respectful in the next segment. The Bears
Sounds
will
good.
Find a way to screw it up. They always do. But it seems like they're headed in the right trajectory as it stands on March 16th.
I like it.
Am I wrong about that? Like,
hey,
I feel like they are.
I just want to know what's going to happen. Are you going to trade Justin Fields or are you going to go with Caleb Williams? It feels like it's the consensus of Caleb Williams.
Correct.
And then what are you going to do for the – I'm almost curious about what you're going to do for the second first-round pick because it feels like you have to go offensive line because there's no point to get – I mean, I'd be excited to get Malik Nabers. I'd be excited to get Romo Dunze or Marvin Harrison Jr., but there's no way he's falling tonight.
No, he's not falling tonight.
He is not falling tonight. I just don't feel like another offensive weapon is the move within that top 10. I mean, of course, well, again, Caleb Williams, that's a different story. I'm saying more for the second pick.
Sure.
Invest in the offensive line or get somebody for the pass rush. That's what I'm looking at.
All still ahead on Saturday tip-off. We respectfully give Pablo Iglesias a Bears fan therapy. We'll do that coming up next. I also want to quiz Riley and Pablo on every team Greg Gard has beaten in the NCAA tournament. We'll see if you're smarter than Riley and Pablo. We'll do that a bit later. Also want to talk about, with the bracket coming up tomorrow, do you have any like bracket traditions? Are there any teams you always pick for or against? We'll talk about that. All still coming up. We're with you till 10:45 this morning. It's a special edition of Saturday Tip-Off right here on 100.5 ESPN, the ESPN app in Wisconsin. On demand.
This is Saturday Tip-Off on ESPN Wisconsin and Wisconsin On Demand.
Time to start thinking about a summer job? Jesse Nelson here, and Madison School and Community Recreation is now hiring for many positions, including day camp and youth program leaders, outdoor adventure staff, support staff for individuals with disabilities, sports instructors and officials, and more. Full and part-time positions with daytime and evening hours are available. No matter your interest, schedule, or location, there's a position for everyone. At MSCR, you can make an immediate impact in the community and gain meaningful experience. Start your summer adventure today. Apply at MSCR.org.
gold medalist Matt Hamilton, judgmental Jim Rutledge, Rutledge and Hamilton.
So you're not special.
Yeah,
it's
so
special.
You're picking on some it's special right. people.
No. You're always the bridesmaid. You are so close to getting married over and over again, then you get dumped at the altar.
You've
in
never
four
had
years.
A guy. Jim, if we want to play this game, we can play this game.
Rutledge and Hamilton with Jim Rutledge and Matt Hamilton. Presented by Coors Light. Weekdays 4 to 6 on 100.5 ESPN. Also brought to you by J&K Security Solutions.
Come see Thanalysis live from Potawatomi Casino Hotel on Friday, March 22nd.
Hey, welcome to another Thanalysis show. And we are coming on today's podcast.
Be there for the first ever live show for Thanasis as he's joined by his brother, none other than the Greek freak, Giannis Antetokounmpo.
I took off my shoes and I was like, go crazy, go hoop. That's all it was.
Stay tuned for info. Tickets are on sale soon. Thanalysis live in Potawatomi Casino Hotel on Friday, March 22nd.
When it comes to security for your home and family, you want a winner, and we found one when we placed our trust with J&K Security Solutions. This is Greg Gard. Kim and Jeff hit the game-winning shot for us with the Control 4 home technology system. Home or away, from our smartphones, we can open the garage door, dim the lights, turn on the TV, as well as arm the security system. That's convenience as well as peace of mind. Let J&K Security Solutions do for your home or business like they've done for us. Call 255-5799 or online at jksecurity.com.
Stoughton Health, in collaboration with patient and family advisors, seeks to advance the healthcare experience at Stoughton Health by providing a forum for past patients and families to provide feedback on a variety of healthcare and other related topics. Advisors offer constructive feedback on their personal journey at Stoughton Health, helping to elevate the patient experience and increase satisfaction. Interested? Please call Amy at 608-873-2308.
Since 1956, Holman Lindsay Paints has been making paint in Wisconsin for Wisconsin. Because of their commitment to making great paint for Wisconsinites, Holman Lindsay has grown over the years to 26 locations in this great state. Headquarters in Sun Prairie with a state-of-the-art facility, Holman Lindsay has the paints you need to make your job better. From do-it-yourself to professional, Holman Lindsay has paint for everyone. Visit one of their local locations today in Madison, Sun Prairie, Middleton, and Janesville.
We tend not to think about right now, but right now in front of us is victory over cancer. Right now, cancer research funded by the V Foundation is leading to better treatments and saving lives. When you give to the V Foundation, 100% of your donation goes directly to game-changing cancer research. Victory over cancer is there for the taking by you. Donate at V.org because today's cancer research is tomorrow's victory.
Don't give up. Don't ever give up.
Hey, hungry? And your heart is ticking for chicken? Well, take a quick turn into Quick Trip, because we got
no ordinary chicken.
Yeah, go wild with wings. Next level super wings with trusty sidekick and sauces. Or let's talk tender. Quick chick tenders. Love me tenders. Love me some quick tenders. Ours are bigger, better, tastier. Or if you're feeling good old school comfort fried chicken, we got it. Hand breaded down homier than anywhere. Quick Trip. Saving your nuggets from ordinary.
NBA Sunday.
Durant for three, and he hits a high arcing three.
It's almost sinful that they could do that.
Kevin Durant and the Phoenix Suns storm into Milwaukee to go head-to-head with Giannis and the Bucks. Sunday on Madison's home of the Bucks, 100.5 ESPN.
We got a new nickname for Riley?
We do. Mr. Reliable's running the show today.
What a time to come up with a nickname in March where legends are made.
Riley Yauch is a March legend. So a little behind the scenes, he's also a terrific graphic designer.
Mr. Reliable.
He's always come through for us. You're also Mr. Reliable. You always come through for us when we ask you to.
I can't be Mr. Reliable if Mr. Reliable is here on the other side of the glass.
That's a good point. So when you're back on Monday,
you heard the horn? That was a big, important thought. That's like the light bulb popping up right above your head.
I gotta be honest, I don't think I've ever worked with anybody who has more fun playing radio than Pablo Iglesias. Right? Like, he is so fascinated by the drops we have. He just loves... I remember the first time you filled in on Rutledge and Hamilton, and you were in my ear every commercial break when I was producing that show at the time.
Okay.
And you would come in, you'd be like, hey, can you play this song for me?
I was playing a lot of requests. Hopefully I wasn't being a brat with the music.
No, I thought it was fun because it's sometimes you get people, you know, that maybe don't work in radio full time like we do. Obviously you're on the TV side, and they'll come in and they just kind of do it, and it feels like a chore to them. And you come in here and you legitimately have fun with it.
Yeah, and it's funny that we were just talking about, well, more so because of traffic, but L.A., but that was where I did one of my internships in college, was with the Petros and Money show out in Los Angeles, and a couple other radio shows for KLAC, and they just had so much fun, and it's awesome. Like, it was cool just to get to see how they interacted, and for the interns, they always love to bring them on and razz them, so I went on air a couple times on L.A., but yeah, it's just fun. So I know kind of a little bit of the background, and yeah, it's just about chopping it up and having a good time.
Well, like your internship in LA, I'm going to bring you on and razz you right now because I want to talk about the Chicago
Bears.
Let's
do it. I'm ready.
I don't know if this is going to be therapy, but you said that this sounded sarcastic. I'm gonna be serious when I say this, respectfully.
There we go. Thank you.
I'm asking you a question. Is the Bears offense going to be good in 2024 as they acquire Keenan Allen? They have DJ Moore. They sign DeAndre Swift and will likely draft Caleb Williams with the first overall pick. Is the Bears offense going to be good in 2024?
This is a very strange Twilight Zone episode that I think we're going into where the Bears offense is. It actually feels good with Shane Walter. I'm curious to see what he does. I'm curious to see what he does with this Bears offense. I like the fact that they just have weapons now. I was really happy with DJ Moore coming on board and him being the clearly established number one. He still will be the number one, but I think that was the job that this offense or this organization needed to do, was find and establish number two. Mm-hmm. Darnell Mooney is talented. He's fun. He's fast, but he actually really you know, moved back, took a few steps back last season. I'm excited for him with the Falcons. I can't wait to see what he does. I think he's a talented player. Just wasn't in the mix. And it's funny, too. They're just showing Davante Adams cooking the Bears right now, too. So we're watching on SportsCenter. But anyway, let's move on. Go back to my beloved Bears.
Yeah, your beloved Bears.
The Kawhi laugh, too. I love that.
Well, you have a Bears fan chiming in on the ESPN Madison text line, 844-770-3776.
We're so back.
He is listed in the text line as Ryan the Psychedelic Advisor. I would imagine Jim Rutledge titled him that,
okay.
Your fellow Bears fan. He just said, bear down, ask me whatever. I'll answer. He's volunteering to take your spot. And then he said, Ryan Poles is going to pull something off.
Yeah. Well, the fact that he got Keenan Allen for a fourth-round draft pick just feels like a bag of peanuts, and we're ready to ride.
Yeah.
Like, I'm excited for that.
I'm fascinated by the NFC North as a whole next year.
Yeah.
Because obviously the Packers are in an interesting spot as they move on from Aaron Jones. They bring in Josh Jacobs. They bring in Xavier McKinney as a new safety. But I feel like everybody in the NFC North should probably draft a cornerback. Because you look at the Vikings, who have a great duo of Justin Jefferson, probably the best non-quarterback in all of football right now, and then Jordan Addison, a young up-and-coming receiver. I just mentioned the Bears' tandem of DJ Moore and Keenan Allen. The Packers have some nice young pieces at receiver, and obviously Detroit has a really nice receiver in Amon Ross St. Brown. I didn't even mention some of the tight ends in the division, right? Obviously Cole Kmet in Chicago, as well as TJ Hockenson in Minnesota. I feel like everybody needs some defensive back help in the NFC North. It's going to be a fun offensive division in 2024.
Yeah, that's what I was saying, too, with where are they going to go with the second pick that they have in the first round. I don't think, again, I feel like it should be Joe Alt or from Notre Dame.
Get some O-line help.
Yeah, the O-line. I think the O-line is the primary thing for me. If not, though, if Kool-Aid McKinstry's still on the board.
Such a great name.
That's fun. I think I just want him for the name.
That's what I always say.
I want Kool-Aid McKinstry.
Now, I do have a little PTSD because the last time the Packers selected a defensive back from Alabama with a cool name, they brought in Ha Ha Clinton Dix.
Yeah.
Former Bear as well.
Former Bear. Chicago Bear legend.
Didn't work out very well for either team.
Mm-hmm.
So I worry Kool-Aid McKinstry will just be more of the same because he has an awesome name and played D-back at Alabama. But maybe I'm just being naive.
I don't know. We'll see. I do agree with you, though. It does come down to the secondary as well. And I'm excited. It's been a while since... I mean, well, let's even look at the Packers team, too, that how flashy in the passing realm that they were. You know, I mean, I think just even looking at the NFC North and what it's going to be with Aaron Jones, hopefully you're okay. Are you okay?
After seeing him do the skull chant, did you see this?
Was it cringe or did it hurt? Did did that fuel you more so? You're like, oh, this guy's just doing this just to try to get
everything you just asked me. The answer is yes. It was cheesy. It was gross. It made me upset. You can tell he's hurt by the Packers, which is unfortunate. That's not my fault, right? Like, he's a Packers legend, always will be. But to go to that opening press conference on a team you traditionally kick their ass and then end it with their stupid, and as a Bears fan, you can agree with me on this. Mm-hmm. That skull chant is the most annoying thing in the entire world that they do at U.S. Bank Stadium in Minneapolis. So to see Aaron Jones end his introductory press conference that way, yeah, that bothered me, Pablo, answer your question. Now this has turned into my therapy session. What's going on here?
We're here to help each other out. Riley, if you need anything, too. Oh, I thought he left the booth for a minute. No, he didn't. He didn't, folks. He's not. He's still in the booth.
No, he's there. Are you okay?
He's doing all the important things while we're just...
Do you need to get anything off your chest?
No, I think I'm good. But I was just going to look up a skull chant, see if I can get a sound drop.
Wow, what a producer. Everybody give him a round of applause.
Mr. Reliable.
Indeed.
This
unbelievable.
Is Mr. Reliable.
Indeed. Incredible. Incredible. So,
where
yeah,
legends are made.
Everything bothers me, but luckily my team knows how to win on a consistent basis.
That's true. I just don't, like I said, I don't really know if it's for the quarterback situation, though. Do I want Caleb Williams?
Yes.
Do I want Justin Fields?
No, you want another bite at the apple.
That's the interesting, well, because even the conversations that I have left and right about Justin Fields, I'm a big Justin Fields fan, don't get me wrong, but then that comes with other situations in terms of the risk of picking up the fifth-year option. I mean, even the Packers, granted, Jordan Love's trajectory versus how Justin Fields' career has been playing out very different. But,
yep.
I mean, let's also look at it, too. The early on in the season, I mean, it almost...
It looked ugly.
At the moment when the Packers picked up his fifth year, did you expect him to be this... You wanted him to be the quarterback he is today, yes, I'm sure.
You hadn't even seen him yet at that point, right? Because I don't think they technically picked up his fifth year, but they gave him an extension of sorts.
Yes.
A small extension to keep him around for a while. He hadn't played yet. And then, you know, when they were, whatever it was, 2-5 in the middle of October and going through a four-game losing streak, I thought the Packers were going to have a shot at Caleb Williams, to mm-hmm. be real honest with you. And then he was, I mean, statistically, the best quarterback in the NFL down the stretch of the season in the second half. And it looks like Love will play the role as the franchise quarterback for the Packers. Will he be as good as Aaron Rodgers or Brett Favre was? Probably not, realistically, right? Those are two of the greatest quarterbacks of all time in NFL history. But Love clearly learned a lot in his 3 years sitting behind Rodgers and can clearly play the position very well. And Brian Gutekunst, the general manager of the Packers, is setting him up for success with some of the pieces around him. So I like where things are at. Now, the thing with Justin Fields is, and I do want to know this, and again, respectfully, and I do mean this, does it concern you that nobody's traded for him yet and that it seems like the value continues to go down for a guy like Justin Fields? Because at this point, as we're a week into free agency now, I thought for sure he'd be gone for a third-round pick or something of the like.
I wonder if Pittsburgh is still trying to figure something out. Because
I wonder that as well.
Because, well, Kenny Pickett knew that once Russell Wilson was there, his job was gone, yep, or it was not a safe. It was not a safe bet. So I'm curious to see, because Mike Tomlin just still seems like a huge fan, regardless. And who knows? I don't think they're going to trade the house for Justin Fields. Maybe that means it's probably a good play for Pittsburgh, honestly, to try to get him at a better discount. I would still like to see a draft pick, but, you know, honestly, I will take a second. Maybe. I don't know. I don't know if
anybody's going to offer that.
That's the thing. The team really wanted a first-round pick, and I'm like, I don't know if... I'd be excited if they landed another first-round pick, but I don't know if his value is really worth it. His numbers got a little better over time, but I don't know if it's truly... I mean, again, let's even look at the market from a different aspect. Again, I think money probably had to come into it. With Keenan Allen, granted, he's 32, aging receiver, mm-hmm, still... aging all-pro receiver. Mm-hmm. That's just what it is. Fourth-round pick. So, I mean, for a guy still of that merit, again, different fields, different paths where they're currently at in their careers. A
lot of money, too.
Yeah. So it's kind of just thinking, I'm like, okay, like if, you know, people see like Keenan Allen in a fourth round at that same level, I guess, in a way, if you will, then how can you really make – you get what I'm saying? How can you really make the argument of like Justin Fields should be – first round pick worthy too in terms of that swap? I don't know if I see that relation. So it does make me a little worried. I think they are going to trade him, though. Just feels like that's the move, just because, again, if you were to ask me, again, big fan of Justin Fields, but if you could ask me if he was the guy point blank, I don't know if I can give you a straight answer, to be totally honest. That's what this whole rambling is, too, to be honest.
But I'm with you, right? And as much as I like to dunk on the Bears and make fun of them, he is a weird case. Mm-hmm. Because he has these flashes where it's like, okay, maybe he is the guy, but the pocket presence just isn't there. And is that something you can grow into? Maybe. But he needs a situation in which he can learn. And Pittsburgh makes a ton of sense.
A consistent situation, too. Right. And I think it's just it's a possibility of a coexisting situation where he's a good quarterback, but this is just not the situation for him in Chicago. You know, it's those two things where it's like, just because it's not working in Chicago doesn't mean it can't work somewhere else. So that's kind of where I sit. And also partly from the business side of it, too, though. Picking up that fifth year does feel risky, more so from where does that put you as a franchise if you want to keep bringing in big name guys? Because at the moment, or at least going into the offseason, they were somewhere in the $60 million room with cap space. It's a lot of money. I think
that a lot of money.
They were the third highest team, I believe. They were definitely in the top five with the largest cap space going into this offseason. And then, so if you bring in Caleb Williams, you get a full rookie contract. I know that his dad, which people are kind of comparing with LeVar Ball and all that.
I've heard.
Yeah, so that just, you know, that feels like a strange situation. Just from X's and O's in terms of putting him on a rookie deal, though, you get to start over, you get a guy on his rookie deal, and then you can focus on the skill positions. I think either way, they're trying to set up either quarterback for success. I think Justin Fields gets the weapons that he very much needs, or Caleb Williams coming in to this weird situation. Do I want to play in Chicago? Oh, okay, now I've got Keenan Allen as well. Now I've got DeAndre Swift. Now I've got DJ Moore. And then Gerald Everett and Cole Kmet, who's coming off a good year too. So, I mean, five weapons for a rookie who at least felt like, in terms of, like, you know, what the narrative is that he's kind of shaky about being in Chicago, gives him a better situation or makes him feel a little better if he were to come into to this offense.
How much of your mind does this consume? It seems like you think about this a lot.
It's because it's just been, I've never been, it, and you could probably ask any other Bears fan, probably Jim too. I have never been this excited, anxious, nervous about the draft. Like, compared to this year. Like,
well, two picks in the top 10, including the number one overall pick. That's a hefty load there.
And it truly is. I will just honestly say it's wherever it takes, it will be a franchise-altering situation. I think it's fair to say wherever they decide to go, this is a franchise-altering year.
100%. I fully agree with you on that. As you hear Owen Wilson with a wow chime in.
Great to have him in the studio.
Thanks
today.
For being here, Owen. Appreciate that.
Wow.
Before we take a break, Pablo, real quick, did you see the picture circulating the other week of Matt LaFleur and Matt Eberflus?
I did see
courtside
that.
At the Marquette game. Did that bother you as a Bears fan?
You know, it is what it is. Their coach is chopping it up. I mean, if anything, look, it's people are going to make memes about it, but at the same point, If you wanna pick brains, you gotta. I mean, it was even like with Kobe Bryant's. I guess in a way, I mean, I'm not. I gotta hold it off here. I'm not calling Matt LaFleur Kobe Bryant or anything.
Yeah, you are.
So I know you're gonna run away
with
that.
Two goats. Yeah.
But it's also like when players get together at the All-Star game or something like that, or what Kobe would say too to, you know, the younger guys, or even vice versa, when Michael Jordan was talking with Kobe, they always like chop left and right. I mean, if you want to learn from the best, you have to go to the best. You can't just, you know, I mean, it's, I guess that's just kind of what it is.
Cut that. You hear that, Riley? You hear what he just said? Matt LaFleur is the best. That's what I just heard out of Pablo Iglesias' mouth.
That's getting cut.
Okay, good.
I suddenly have to leave now. This has been fun. But no, truly though, I think that's just what it is. I actually do think Matt LaFleur is a very smart coach. He's really strategic. I love the offense. I know you're just putting material up left and right for me to just talk about how much I enjoy Matt LaFleur and all that. But, I don't know. I think it doesn't really bother me too much. I mean, it's kind of funny to have, like, the what the heck are you doing, Eberflus? But the meeting of the minds, or the meeting of the mats, I guess, if you will.
I like that.
There we go. But see, ding, ding, ding. I'm getting more points, man. You know, I don't know what the points
are.
Yeah,
the points, if we're playing around the horn, I think it's like 48-0 right now.
Are you in the negative?
I might be in the negative. I might be in the negative.
I'm not keeping track, but I can start keeping track.
Well, I know Pablo's winning. Yeah, I know Pablo's winning.
The next hour. Yeah, we still got another hour together, so.
I don't want you to keep track because I just don't. I don't want to know how bad I lose. So it's fine. Yeah, there's my negative points.
Yes.
Yeah.
Hey, just learn from your peers. That's all you can do.
Fair enough. Fair enough. All right. Greg Gard has won 6 NCAA tournament games. Can Riley and Pablo tell me the 6 teams they've beaten since 2016? Riley, you are a senior at UW-Madison.
I am.
Pablo went to Bradley. So I think more of this.
With Jesse? Maybe. We crossed paths. I think he was 3 years older than me, something like that.
How old are you? I could tell you.
How old am I?
Yeah.
I'm 28. I'm going to be 29 this
year. I think
year.
He's 31. So, yeah, that would make sense.
Wow. All right.
I might be wrong on that. Maybe I can't tell you. But
Bradley deserves to be dancing, all right? They won like 20. I forgot what their record is. But anyway, they're not going to be dancing.
They're not going to be dancing, no. Brian Wardle, former UW Green Bay coach. I covered him during his time up there.
Marquette legend, too. Played Marquette with Dwayne
legend.
Wade.
Yeah, Marquette Come legend. On, I don't know about legend. That might be strong.
Yeah.
He was a good player, but...
He was on the Final Four team.
Yeah, he was a good player.
So therefore...
But he wasn't Travis Diener or Steve Novak or Dwayne Wade.
Yeah, or Dwayne Wade.
Yeah, or Dwayne Wade, most importantly. Yeah, Dwayne Wade was pretty good. Anyway, can Pablo and Riley combine to tell me the 6 teams Greg Gard has beaten since 2016 in the NCAA tournament? We will test their knowledge coming up next as we wrap up the 9 o'clock hour. This is a special edition of Saturday Tip-Off on ESPN Madison alongside Pablo Iglesias of WKOW. Alex Droff with you right here on ESPN Madison.
Score!
This is Saturday Tip-Off on ESPN Wisconsin and Wisconsin On Demand.
The biggest names in the basketball world.
Dame Dollar Lillard.
Having fun and honest conversations.
He puts it in the shoe, right? And sets the tone for brothers and sisters and family.
Every week, Thanasis Adetokounmpo sits down with special guests on Thanalysis Show.
Fantastic.
Find Thanalysis Show on Spotify, Apple, or wherever you get your podcasts. And on YouTube by searching Thanalysis Show.
Hi, this is Lee, inviting you to Ruth's Chris Steakhouse in Middleton. We got a great happy hour every day of the week from 4 o'clock to 7, and our patio during the summer is open too. If you're getting married, special occasion, a birthday, anniversary, or even a business meeting, we've got all the accommodations right here at Ruth's Chris Steakhouse. You work hard, and sometimes you're not sure what you want to do, where you want to spend your money. I want to encourage you to come into Ruth's Chris Steakhouse and say hello. It'd be a pleasure to meet you.
Spring will be here before you know it, and so will Mark Osiki's 6th annual Casting for Kids Fishing Tournament, Saturday, May 18th on the Madison Chain of Lakes. Created to help children who are fighting cancer at American Family Children's Hospital, UW-Carbone Cancer Center. There's a limit of 80 boats for a fun day on the water before 2:30 happy hour at Alliant Energy Center, a silent auction, dinner, and a live auction at 4 o'clock. Help us help the kids. Casting for Kids, Saturday, May 18th. Sign up or donate at castingforkids.org.
Big trailers and big opportunity. Since 1962, Stoughton Trailers has been a family-owned and operated business. With competitive wages and excellent benefits, plus growth and advancement opportunities, Stoughton Trailers is an exciting place to grow your career. Join the collaboration, innovation, and dynamic team atmosphere at Stoughton Trailers. With positions now open in production, operations, finance, sales, engineering, supply chain, and more. Go to stojobs.com to apply today. Stoughton Trailers, big trailers, big opportunity.
To those who've ever dreamt of their perfect event, those dreams are worthy and they are possible. Hi, it's Jeffrey from Celebrations Entertainment. With hard work, passion, and great music, we will make your event dreams a reality. Every event is a labor of love, with one-on-one planning, customization, and flawless execution. Bringing your event to life is what we do. For a fun, memorable event, visit celebrationsentertainment.com. That's celebrationsentertainment.com.
At Gruber Losses, we take great pride in helping those who have trusted us after a serious accident. Our team has the knowledge, resources, and experience to get you the results you deserve. Don't wait to get the help you need. Make the right call. Call Gruber Losses today. Proud partner of Wisconsin Athletics. One call, that's all.
Hey, it's Bobby Portis, and I love playing basketball in Milwaukee. When I drive down the lane, I move fast and make sudden moves to drive to the hoop and score. But when I'm behind the wheel in the driving lane, I control my drive. I don't speed or make sudden movements. Speeding and reckless driving are the leading causes of traffic injuries and deaths in Wisconsin. Do what I do. Control your drive. Don't speed. Don't be reckless. Zero in Wisconsin. Together we can save lives. Wisconsin DOT.
From the biggest plays on the court to the comments made in the locker room after, an in-depth recap of every Bucks game in 6 minutes. No more, no less. Bucks in 6 provides game recaps for every game. Hear the high-flying dunks from Giannis.
Puts it on the floor, spins down the lane, and plunges it through.
Or the deep threes from Dame.
Dame time has arrived with 107.
Bucks in 6 on the Bucks Plus Audio Network. Find it now on Bucks.com/plus or on Spotify, Apple, and wherever you get your podcasts.
NBA Monday on ESPN Radio. Jalen Brunson and the New York Knicks storm into San Francisco to face Steph Curry and the Golden State Warriors, who are fighting to escape the play-in tournament. Coverage begins Monday at 9:30 Eastern on ESPN Radio and on ESPN. Presented by Indeed.
How many days did I spend thinking about how you did me wrong, wrong, wrong? Lived in the shade you were throwing till all of my sunshine was gone, gone, gone. And I couldn't get away from ya. Hit my feelings more than Drake, so yeah. Your name on my lips, tongue tied. Free rent living in my mind. But then something happened one magical night. I forgot that you existed.
Taylor Swift bringing us in on a Saturday morning. Nothing like that. Ron S., which is Ron in the Key, chimes in on YouTube, says, Pablo, you haven't learned anything from Strophe, right?
I've learned a lot of things.
Not to do?
Of what not to do?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I appreciate the honesty. It's a special edition of Saturday Tip-Off.
That's what friends are for. We're not just, you know, we're not just sport media colleagues. We're friends, Alex.
I would agree. Yeah. I would agree. We've gotten into some shenanigans together.
We sure have. Yeah, we definitely have. We definitely have.
We'll leave that off the air as your parents are literally in the room.
Yeah, I'm sure my parents would love to hear those types of things.
Saturday tip-off with you on your Saturday morning ESPN Madison, 9:58 a.m. alongside Pablo Iglesias, our special guest from WKOW. I'm Alex Strofe, Riley Yauch helping us out running the show. All right.
Mr. Reliable.
That's right. I'm Mr. Irrelevant. That's the name of my show, Monday, Wednesday, Friday. You can catch here on the ESPN Madison YouTube channel if you're rocking with us there. He's Mr. Reliable, though. Mr. Reliable. How is your trivia knowledge when it comes to college basketball? Because you're a UFC guy. I know, like, that's your sport.
Yeah, I would say so.
College basketball, how's your knowledge in that department?
Mediocre, okay. I would say.
Pablo, you've covered the Badgers the last 3 years. I think they've only won one tournament game since you've covered them.
Technically two, because I got here.
Oh, okay.
I got here. I'm trying to remember who they beat, but it was in Purdue.
Don't tell me yet.
It was at Purdue, so that's all I can remember.
Okay. So I want to test your knowledge. I want to see how you do here in the final segment of the 9 o'clock hour. Greg Gard took over the team in December of 2015, meaning the 2016 NCAA tournament, which they made the Sweet 16 in, was his first. He has won six NCAA tournament games against six different opponents. Can you tell me how many? Let me rephrase it this way. How many of the six opponents can you guys get? I'm going to let you collaborate. Just don't cheat. Who have they beaten? Good music choice.
Colgate?
Colgate is one. Yes, that's correct.
And
that is the most recent. 2022.
I have three of them. During the break, I was working on them.
Go for it.
2016, I remember we beat Xavier.
Yes, the Murray game.
Yes, the buzzer beater from Bronson Koenig.
That is correct.
I don't know who we beat in the round of 64 that year, though.
It was a 10 seed. There's your hint.
A 10 seed. Okay.
So Xavier and Colgate. You have Xavier in 2016, Colgate in 2022.
In 2017, we beat Virginia Tech.
And
Villanova.
Wow!
I remember that year. I was a huge Nigel Hayes guy.
Okay.
I love Nigel Hayes.
Guy.
I love that team.
Okay, so you're missing.
That's it.
You're missing the round of 64 in 2016, and you are missing the only win in 2021. You've got four of the six.
Okay.
Wasn't
round of 10 seed?
It was like they were six, and they beat a 12 in 21.
No, they were a 9 in 21. They beat an 8. I'll give you this. It's a blue blood. It's one of the great college basketball schools that they beat in 2021. It's a forgettable game, though. I would not have gotten this.
Oh, UConn.
UConn.
I thought they lost to them, though, in the next round.
They lost to Baylor that year.
UNC.
You got it. UNC, North Carolina. So you are only missing. I'm impressed. You really rifled these off, Riley. I'm proud of you as the UW soon-to-be alum. I heard somebody call alum. It was Colin Russo, who will also soon to be a UW alum.
Mm-hmm.
Our other senior at UW who works with us here at ESPN Madison. He said the word alum. He's going to earn his college degree.
Wow.
Yeah, he referred to alumni as alum yesterday.
The alumni.
Alum.
That feels
this
too
man's
close
gonna
to
have
Illuminati.
A college degree in a couple weeks.
We are in the same class. Yeah. He is a classmate. We'll walk together. So.
Arm in arm, will he walk together?
Maybe.
Right back to the
shoulders, or you get on his shoulder. I think
I'm
100%
idea.
Lighter, so I would be the guy on top of his shoulders.
Yeah.
Just be a very tall person. There we go.
You're missing a 9 seed. It is a Tech. That's your hint.
A Tech.
It's one of the Techs.
A 9 seed. And we already got Virginia Tech, and I don't think we beat them twice. Maybe we did?
Oh, no, not a Tech. I was looking at Virginia Tech. I'm sorry.
I'm just letting Mr. Reliable just go for it.
Number 10 seed in 2016. Has an NFL team. It is a city with an NFL team that we've talked about on this program.
On this program.
Has it?
Chicago?
No.
Georgia Tech?
No, not a Tech.
Not
Get
a tech.
That
oh,
out of your mind. I screwed
tech.
Up. Not a
oh,
Tech.
Oh, wait. That's a Tech.
That's
a tech.
That's a technical foul.
Give us
yes.
give us an extra free throw for that one.
It is a city with an NFL team that we've talked about.
School from Minneapolis?
No. Nope. Not Minneapolis.
Pitt?
Yeah.
Nice.
Pittsburgh. Tennessee, Pittsburgh. Future home of Justin Fields. And the alum of Kenny Pickett, who was also brought up on the show.
I was just thinking about this in between our break. He's definitely worth more than at least somewhere in the top three. Top, or not top three pick. First, second, third round Justin Fields. Because Mac Jones, what was it, a fourth round pick?
Yeah. Mac
Justin
Jones stinks.
Fields is a lot better than Mac Jones. All right, I feel
okay,
like I'm
but
going,
hold on, hold
I'm going
on.
Ben Bruss
before
here.
You go
I'm
on
channeling
this rant,
my Ben Bruss
before you go on
yelling
this rant,
energy.
You have to understand that's not a high bar.
I'm just saying.
Like, if you're trying to prop up Justin Fields, knocking down Mac Jones ain't the way to do it.
I'm just saying, you know, just the value's stupid. You know what? Let's just go with it that way. I'm just going to go with that argument that the value is stupid and how people are trying to figure this out. Because if the Patriots can get Mac Jones and send him off for a fourth round for him to be a backup somewhere, the Bears can absolutely get at least first, second, third round pick. Wherever the heck it lands.
It's going to be in the third.
So be it. He's better than Mac Jones.
Cool.
Riley is a Packers fan. To back up Jordan Love, would you send a third to Chicago?
A third round pick.
Yeah. Would you send a third round pick to Chicago to make Justin Fields the backup quarterback ahead of Sean Clifford for the Packers? I would not.
Ooh, maybe.
Clifford, the big red QB.
I'd think about it.
I would think about it too. But I don't think I'd do it. I think it causes a weird riff.
Yeah.
Justin Fields is weird because he has starter energy.
Don't you dare. Yeah. Don't you dare call Justin Fields weird.
I'm not calling him weird. I'm calling the situation weird.
He might be weird.
He went to Ohio State. You got to be a little weird to go to Ohio State.
They don't go to Ohio State to play school.
All right.
No. Whoa.
Third rounders, just looking at it from last year, Tank Dell was a third rounder.
That's a good.
So I'm just saying from a player comparison, Hendon Hooker, backup quarterback from the Lions, Tennessee guy. Sidney Brown, Illinois guy, plays for the Eagles, great safety. I'm just saying. Tucker Kraft,
South Dakota State. Go Jackrabbits.
Okay. I'm just saying.
All right, we got to take a break. When we come back, I'm very curious on bracket philosophy. Like, how many fill out before you get to your final picks? How many different groups are you in? How many different brackets are you filling in? Do you have a system? Right? Are you flipping a coin? Are you picking it on colors? I'm always, because everybody's different. Everybody has some sort of bracket philosophy. So we're going to figure out Riley's. We're going to figure out Pablo's. I'll tell you about mine coming up next. Election Sunday tomorrow. It's a special edition of Saturday Tip-Off right here on ESPN Madison.
No more waiting to see a general surgeon. Stoughton Health has you covered. We accept over 160 insurances, including Anthem Blue Cross, Blue Shield, Cigna, Dean Health Plan, Humana, and Quartz. Enjoy easy access at Stoughton Health, where most general surgery appointments are available within a week. When it comes to your procedure, trust board-certified general surgeon Dr. Aaron Schwab. At Stoughton Health, we are proud to provide you with exceptional, personalized service. Learn more at stoughtonhealth.com.
The GRB Rays have established themselves as one of the top baseball programs in the Midwest and the country. GRB Academy offers training programs for players of all ages and skill levels. Learn from some of the best baseball coaches in the area and find the program that fits your training goals and your schedule. Spots are filling up fast, so visit grbacademy.com to sign up now. That's grbacademy.com. GRB Academy, baseball for the serious player.
I love playing sports, especially for my school.
And that's because school sports are special. It's where it's safe to fail. It's where we're taught resilience, where our fear becomes confidence. It's where we learn to get back up after every fall. School sports are where 7.8 million students go from I can't to I can.
This message presented by the WIAA and the Wisconsin Athletic Directors Association.
Life's better with American Family Insurance because our home policies help protect your dreams and come with peace of mind. Save up to 25% by bundling home, auto, and life. American Family Insurance. Get a quote, find an agent at amfam.com.
Products not available in every state. Discounts may not apply to all coverages on an auto or home policy. Discounts do not apply to life insurance policies. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating companies, American Family Life Insurance Company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
This is Derek Engler. You're listening to a Good Karma Brands radio station, 100.5 ESPN WTLX, Monona, Madison.
Saturday tip-off rolls on in here Saturday morning alongside Pablo Iglesias of WKOW, who's graced us with his presence.
That was a very nice soothing. This is a soothing
what
way
song
to
is
go.
This?
Moody Blue by Elvis Presley.
I didn't expect to be listening to Elvis Presley this morning.
You mean you don't wake up in the morning and listen to Elvis? Have you seen the Elvis movie, by the way?
So
now
good.
We're here to talk about
that's
films.
Austin Butler, right?
Yes. Yeah. Who's also in Dune Part 2. So, haven't seen that yet.
I got to be honest with you. The only thing I know about Dune Part 2 is the, how do I phrase
Willy
this?
Willy Wonka's in it. Is that all you know?
No, not where I was. I was going with the popcorn cup that people are taking out of context on the internet.
Being pretty sus.
Good word, sus.
We can say sus on the radio. Let's just put it that way.
You can say most things on the radio, Pablo.
Can we?
Not everything. Oh. Just most things. I can't describe what it looks like.
Let's see.
I'll let your mind wander. Maybe Google search that, just not on your work laptop if you don't know what we're talking about.
A lot of Star Wars fans see the Starlack pit. I don't know. I mean, I'm getting
now. I don't
I'm
know
getting
what you're even talking about.
Yeah, yeah, right.
Riley,
yeah, I know what you're talking about.
Right. It's. I mean, granted, now I'm just making more and more like sci-fi references, so we're just getting deeper into the hole. But yeah, it's just this weird shaped popcorn bucket, and it's got like a bunch
phallic.
Of
phallic.
Like,
maybe not phallic. That's a bad word.
It's yeah. I don't even know if I can describe this with.
All right,
you know.
let's stop. Saturday tip off. Pablo Iglesias.
Tweet it. Just tweet a picture of it. But actually, what's really funny?
just tweet him. Don't do that, Riley. Don't do that. We don't want you getting suspended.
I will not be tweeting a picture of the Dune 2 popcorn bucket.
What's actually really funny? I have to give my coworkers a shout out. I was supposed to go see it with them, but something came up. And one of my coworkers wanted the popcorn bucket, legitimately told me he goes up to the concessions counter, doesn't even say anything. He just asked, do you have the bucket? And they're like, no, we don't. We're sold out. The fact that they knew.
Do I know this coworker?
No, you don't, unfortunately. Okay. But Austin, got to give him a shout out. That was just a power move where he didn't have to say anything else, just asking if they have,
do you have the bucket?
Bucket. That was it. And they were like, no.
No.
And they just knew. They knew. So it's got
imagine
its own
Austin
reputation.
Austin probably wasn't the first person to ask that question.
No, probably not. So
okay. Anyway, Selection Sunday is tomorrow.
What a transition.
Yeah, I don't know how to get out of that one. Selection Sunday tomorrow, which means your bracket comes out for the NCAA tournament, the men's basketball tournament, following the conclusion, of course, of the Big Ten Tournament Championship tomorrow. Pablo, before I ask you about the NCAA tournament bracket, will the Badgers be playing tomorrow?
Yes.
You think they beat Purdue tonight?
Oh, wait, no. At first, I thought you were asking me if they're in the tournament. I'm like, yes, they are.
Of course they're in the tournament.
Yes, 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 yes. Well, people have been asking me, are they going to make the tournament? I'm like, yes, they are.
Yeah, that's such a dumb question.
There are not 68 teams that are better than the Badgers. You could make a case 20-ish, maybe?
Yeah, 20, 25.
But anyway.
Will they beat Purdue? Pondering.
What's the spread?
7.5.
Take it.
Badgers plus 7.5?
Badgers plus 7.5.
Confidence is very sexy.
So since your parents are here, have them, and they're driving you around. They're your chauffeur today.
Yes.
Have them cross the border so you can place the wager.
That's it.
And then go back to the call center to get your work done.
I'm ready to go. We'll make a trip. Yeah, we'll do it. Just
real quick. Other things you can get in Illinois that you can't get in Wisconsin. Make a pit stop, too. Anyway, NCAA tournament bracket comes out tomorrow. 68 teams will be on said bracket. Now, Pablo, I want to start with you. Do you have any like philosophies or things that you subscribe to that you do on your bracket every year? Are there any like methods to your March Madness, if you will, that you do when filling out your NCAA tournament bracket? Because everybody in the country, it seems like, fills out a bracket. People that don't watch a lick of college basketball fill out brackets just because it is something everybody can talk about, right? It is a cultural phenomenon. So do you do anything special every year on your bracket? Or do you fill out multiple brackets before you get to the final one? How do you attack it when the bracket comes out on Selection Sunday?
I mean, when I was younger, well, actually, one of the teams that I always rode with when I was a high schooler was Wisconsin. And I think the year that I didn't put them in, because they always upset me in like the first or second round, and I was always disappointed. And then the year, I think the year that I stopped sending them to the Final Four, ironically, was the year that they went to the Final Four. So there you go.
So you were bad luck.
Yes. If we're taking away anything for this first hour, or the second hour, rather, is that I was bad luck for the Wisconsin Badgers, and Bo Ryan can look straight at me for all those woeful years. I mean, this isn't necessarily a strategy, but I guess just in general, you never want to bet against Izzo. Maybe, or not bet again, never bet, but you know what I'm saying.
Like, right.
You never know what seed they are, but he's just got the track record. In terms of strategies, for sure filling out multiple brackets, it's almost like a, you know, you don't want to choose this many. You never want to send all the one seeds. That never happens. So you almost want to think about that. But that's where it gets weird, because it's like, well, I like all the one seeds, but then you can't really factor in chaos, because there's no way all the one seeds are going to make it to the Final Four. So then you almost start to overthink in that way. It's like, okay, like, does it make sense that this seed makes it at this point? You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, figuring out, like, the instead of the head-to-head matchup in terms of the teams, what seed is it going to be? Like, I always get weird with those numbers. So I don't know. It's been a while since I've really just took a deep dive into my March Madness, like, strategy bracket. Bracket strategy, excuse me.
Your Final Four seed should always add up to somewhere between 7 and 10.
Ooh.
That's how I attack it. Right? Because especially as of late, there's been high seeds making it. I think Florida Atlantic last year was like an 11 seed in the Final Four.
Jim's alma mater, right? Isn't
That's
he?
Correct.
Yeah. FAU.
Yeah.
Big FAU guy.
Yeah, he jumped on the bandwagon, and then he gets really offended if you tell him he's a bandwagoner because he has a piece of paper from them.
I'm always with the Bradley Braves, so you know what? I'm never going to be a bandwagoner.
I'm so impressed by you and Jesse Nelson, both Bradley alone.
I should have worn my Bradley jersey today, too.
You have a jersey?
I do. It's I'll send you the pictures of what their city alternates look like. It's a pretty crispy one with a Bradley script. Hersey Hawkins, baby. It's a cold jersey, man.
Seattle Supersonics legend.
Yeah. Okay. Come on, man. Bradley Brave legend.
That's terrific. So how many pools do you enter typically? Are you in multiple pools?
Definitely a friend one. Similar to fantasy football. I think there's a consistent one of friends. There's a work one. That one's just kind of for shiggles, I think we can say.
Shiggles?
Blanks and giggles.
Oh, I've never heard that combined like that.
We can say that on the radio. That hopefully.
I think you just beat the system, bro.
I did say it on the radio. You saw with some hesitation as I went for it.
Well, you're a pro radio broadcaster. You make what may be a mistake, and then you acknowledge the mistake for like 30 seconds following that. Yeah, that's what you do, man.
Riley's got the dump button back there. See, I know the dump button too, right? You've got. Please
he does.
Tell me.
It's okay, true. Cool. He didn't use it though. Okay, he didn't use
he
it.
He didn't use it. Mr. Reliable. Going with the hot hand. All right.
Okay.
What are we even talking about at this point?
Riley.
Yeah.
March Madness.
Yes.
Is there a method to your March Madness?
Yeah, so I have several brackets.
Okay, several.
Several brackets.
Okay.
Yeah, so I make one. My first bracket's always like my legit bracket. That's the one I go with for like competitions if I'm betting money,
okay,
anything like that. That's my legit one, and I typically pick more upsets than I should. and it usually is not my best bracket.
So your number one bracket is not your best bracket?
Typically.
Okay, I like that.
Yeah, I try, but it typically isn't. It just is, my basketball knowledge is not there. But then I always have at least one bracket where Wisconsin is the national champion.
Okay, I respect the consistency.
Yep.
Just
in case, because then when they win the national championship, eventually I'll be like, I called it. So
this is the year.
Exactly. Exactly. This is the year.
You know what? I'm not ruling it out.
Yeah.
I'm not ruling it out.
They beat Purdue today. They have to lose, actually, in the Big Ten championship game, because the Big Ten tournament champion has not made it out of the first weekend in like 5 years or a decade. I don't think they might not have made it out of the first weekend since the Badgers won the tournament back in like 2015 or something. I just heard that stat. I might have to fact check myself. But typically they don't fare well.
That's so. Fair.
As they can lose to Nebraska or whoever makes the
Kei-Tominaga would be a fun legend to watch. But yeah, that would be sad if they went out in the first round.
Huh. Yeah. Yeah, so I have a Badgers bracket, and then I'll typically do one. I'll do my favorite logo, a logo bracket.
You do a logo bracket.
I do a logo bracket. I think St. Peter's won in my logo bracket a few years back when they went on their Mielke run, and that actually did really well because they made the Elite Eight.
Right.
So that was awesome.
Okay.
I love their Peacock logo.
They're back this year, right?
Yeah.
They're back in.
Just
they're
beat so Quinnipiac.
Back. They're so bad.
Quinnipiac.
My friend Joe Crofts is in shambles right now.
Who's your friend Joe Crofts?
Joe Crofts. I host a radio show with him on the student station.
WSUM,
shout out.
Ooh.
And we were betting on the game yesterday, and he picked the games we bet on. And he was like, oh, I'm going to play you because I know you. You like picking upsets, so I'm going to give you this, Quinnipiac versus St. Peter's. Because he knew I'd pick St. Peter's just because I like them, and they were not supposed to win the game. And he's like, ha, I got you. You picked St. Peter's. And then St. Peter's won. So
you're good.
I'm good.
All right.
I'm feeling good.
I don't know where we've gone in this segment, but I really like it.
I like the logos. I did do something similar.
That.
It's more of just because of my Bradley Homerism fandom. I mean, when they made the tournament, I definitely filled out a bracket where they were the national champion.
There's a Bradley bracket somewhere.
Oh, yeah.
100%.
The Bradley bracket is out there. I mean, hey, look, they almost, so we can talk about 2020 being the year of what ifs for so many different teams. I think Dayton probably would have been the fun one. You know,
Wisconsin.
Yeah. Well, that too.
Wisconsin would have won it all.
Yeah, Wisconsin. Well, they did. They were the 100%. Big Ten champions. They were the Big Ten champions.
And the ESPN BPI national champions.
That's true.
Exactly.
I still think they should have hung a sarcastic banner for that.
That would have been hilarious.
That would have been really, like, right next to the Michael Finley jersey that's up in the rafters of the
Kohl
Center.
That's great.
2020 ESPN BPI national champions.
Yeah. We were the
Make
only
it very
ones who could
small,
claim it.
Though. Right, like very small. You have to use like binoculars in order to see it.
Just like it's like a T-shirt. They just like spray painted on a T-shirt or something.
And just hanging in the raft. I think that would have been awesome, right? Make a good joke out of something that wasn't
almost
so funny.
Almost did something cool.
Yeah, almost did something cool. Now the thing with my bracket is I've talked about this many times before on the air because I think self-awareness is important as a human quality, Pablo.
Amen.
I have ridiculous self-confidence. I put so much work every year into my final version of my number one bracket. And I find a way to convince myself. So the Wednesday night before the tournament, Randa 64 actually tips off. I never get any sleep because I'm changing. I'm tinkering. I'm changing things in my bracket. I'm like, okay, maybe this 11 seed will upset this 7 seed. Now, I get myself to a point every single year where I'm like, yeah, this is going to be the perfect one. I'm going to be the first person to do it. I'm going to do a perfect bracket. I'm going to get this every first round matchup right. One year in college, I got the first 15 games right.
What?
I was like, I'm going to do it. And then the last game of Thursday, I got wrong. And then I went like 3-16 on Friday, and the bracket was awful.
Wow.
But I had a great start, and then it just didn't matter. So anyway, I get myself to a point every year where I think I've got the bracket down. Obviously, I'm just an idiot. I'm not going to be the first person to get a perfect bracket.
I'll never forget the first year. Who offered $1 billion? Which billionaire?
I don't remember who
was it.
Let's just say it's Mark Cuban because I like Mark Cuban.
Mark Cuban
with quotes.
As you can see for those radio listeners, my air quotes.
I think the five people on YouTube saw it.
The five people. All right. Welcome YouTube.
Well, we've got
people.
A crow today.
All right. Mark Cuban, but I remember with the as the fireworks go off here in Madison during the day.
See, nobody is more fun doing radio. Just start playing random things, Riley. They don't have to make any sense to the conversation we're having because Pablo and his ADD will be getting distracted.
That's it.
I'm down.
Now, ESPN Madison just commented on YouTube. I don't know who on the ESPN Madison account just commented, hell yeah, we got a crew.
That has to be Maddie, right?
I would think. And Corey Sparks, though, says it was Warren Buffett. There you go.
Warren
your
Buffett.
Answer.
Yeah, that's what it was. Comment box of the century, too, by the way.
Yeah, no.
That is a strophe thing, or at least that was, for a second, a strophe thing when we were hanging out a lot. I think it was, I forgot at what point, maybe the summer.
What was a strophe thing?
Where it was just blank, then of the century. Like, whatever we were doing, like, such and such. It's
I still
blank.
Say that.
Oh, I love, see, yeah, that's a strophism. There we go.
Currently, the WIA State Tournament is the tournament of the century.
Yes.
I mean, tell me I'm wrong. There's been three buzzer beaters in eight games.
That's true.
There was a quadruple overtime game that doesn't even count as a buzzer beater.
That's true. There we go. Now, because I was talking about fireworks, I forgot what I was talking about. Where do we? This is just a great journey.
Warren
I'm
Buffett.
So glad
Warren
my parents,
Buffett $1 billion.
Yes, there we go. When that whole thing had
ADD
happened,
ADD galore today.
It's all over the place. And what's great that I have is cold brew coffee, which Cheers. Is totally going to help us in this situation. but I remember it was like everybody was so confident about the billionaire. It's like, oh, I'm gonna get the perfect bracket. It's not that hard. And it was like whatever it was, like a trillionth of a chance or whatever. Like, you know how it is. You have a better chance of winning the Super Bowl, getting struck by lightning, than getting a perp. All those things. And the first game, it was Dayton and Ohio State. And I want to say this was like the – it's Aaron Kraft, right?
Yeah, it
was the Aaron Kraft Ohio State year. Dayton takes them down,
That's
and
right.
it's the first game. Knocks out like almost half of the brackets, if not more, in the nation. Like, how many – I don't even know how many people took Dayton in that game because I'd have to go back and check.
I think it was a 314.
Yeah, it was a 314. And also the best troll the next day, Dayton put on the newspapers, the University of Dayton.
Darn straight.
That was amazing.
You think they got sued for that?
I don't know. I mean
– Because didn't Ohio State a couple of years ago tried to trademark the word the?
Yeah.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I guess, in that sense.
Yeah. They tried to trademark the with the pronunciation of the. I think they
didn't win.
Yeah, they put like – I don't know if they put it in quotes.
How dumb do you have to be to try to trademark the most common word in the English language? Like somebody high up at a university, higher education. Thought it was a good idea to go to the United States trademark or whatever, United States patent. What is it called? I don't know.
Who do you think they sent?
Who do you think he sent? Probably like the university president or something.
Cardale
like,
Jones.
That's the answer I was looking for. I was just looking for an off-the-wall answer.
Jimmy Smith, yeah.
Yes.
And they tried to trademark one of the
Justin
most common
Fields.
Words.
Yeah, they said Justin Fields.
For a third round pick. All right.
Hey,
we needed to go to break 10 minutes ago. So we ran a little late with our ADHD and cold brew. Shout out to Warren Buffett. He's Pablo Iglesias. I'm Alex Stroff. Riley Yock with us as well, running the show here on ESPN Madison. Do you believe in St. Patrick's Day? Is tomorrow the St. Patrick's Day of the century?
What do you mean, do I believe in St. Patrick's Day? Do I believe in it?
We'll talk about it next. It's Saturday Tip-Off on ESPN Madison.
This is Saturday Tip-Off on ESPN Wisconsin and Wisconsin On Demand.
If you're looking for a special piece of jewelry for any occasion, Condon Jewelers is always there for you. Condon Jewelers has the best selection of jewelry you'll ever find and guaranteed to have the lowest prices in the Madison area. Free shipping is always available. Visit CondonJeweler.com or call 241-3406 and ask for Jim the owner, who's at the store every day. Shop locally. Condon Jewelers, the jeweler on the east side, the jeweler on your side.
At Gruber Law Offices, we take great pride in helping those who have trusted us after a serious accident. Our team has the knowledge, resources, and experience to get you the results you deserve. Don't wait to get the help you need. Make the right call. Call Gruber Law Offices today, proud partner of Wisconsin Athletics. One call, that's all.
Evan, Canty, and Michelle are unsportsmanlike.
What's Vegas Midwest?
Madison, where I went to college, is very fun. You know that, Smalls. You've been there.
It's not Madison.
It's not Madison. You love Madison.
I love Madison. It is not Las Vegas. It is not Central Vegas.
So is there no Central Vegas then?
Unsportsmanlike. Weekdays from 5 to 9 on 100.5 ESPN.
It's official. 2023 was the biggest jackpot year on record at Ho-Chunk Gaming Madison. Check out these totals. We had over 57,000 jackpots and more than $134 million in winnings. This shatters our previous record year, and we have no intention of stopping here. And with our 95% average payout, we continue to be the official home of the big win right here in Madison. Let's keep it going in 2024 with even more jackpots at Ho-Chunk Gaming Madison.
Good Karma Brands is proud to be an equal opportunity employer. Our policy is to provide equal opportunity employment, development, and advancement to all current and potential teammates. If you are an organization that maintains a job bank, provides employment information, or gives job referrals, you may request to be placed on the station's mailing list for future career opportunities. To learn more about careers at Good Karma Brands, please email careers@goodkarmabrands.com.
When it comes to security for your home and family, you want a winner, and we found one when we placed our trust with J&K Security Solutions. This is Greg Gard. Kim and Jeff hit the game-winning shot for us with the Control 4 home technology system. Home or away, from our smartphones, we can open the garage door, dim the lights, turn on the TV, as well as arm the security system. That's convenience as well as peace of mind. Let J&K Security Solutions do for your home or business like they've done for us. Call 255-5799 or online at jksecurity.com.
Stoughton Health, in collaboration with patient and family advisors, seeks to advance the healthcare experience at Stoughton Health by providing a forum for past patients and families to provide feedback on a variety of healthcare and other related topics. Advisors offer constructive feedback on their personal journey at Stoughton Health, helping to elevate the patient experience and increase satisfaction. Interested? Please call Amy at 608-873-2308.
Since 1956, Holman Lindsay Paints has been making paint in Wisconsin for Wisconsin. Because of their commitment to making great paint for Wisconsinites, Holman Lindsay has grown over the years to 26 locations in this great state. Headquarters in Sun Prairie with a state-of-the-art facility, Holman Lindsay has the paints you need to make your job better. From do-it-yourself to professional, Holman Lindsay has paint for everyone. Visit one of their local locations today in Madison, Sun Prairie, Middleton, and Janesville.
On the air, on demand, on social, on Wisconsin Sports. Serving Wisconsin sports fans. This is 100.5 ESPN.
I got my mind set on St. Patrick's Day. Do you believe in St. Patrick's Day?
Yes! Do you believe? I was really trying to go for the do you believe in miracles.
Do you believe?
Do you believe in St. Patrick's Day? Yes!
Saturday tip-off on your Saturday morning, 10:29 a.m. Going to be with you on the eve of St. Patrick's Day. I'm Alex Strope with special guest Pablo Iglesias from WKOW, Riley Auk, young Riley Auk with the mullet and all, running the show for us here at the Everlight Solar Studio.
Does Notre Dame play today too? Because I don't know if you remember, this was a first four game when they played on the eve of St. Patrick's Day.
Oh, yeah.
And it was a buzzer beater that they hit past midnight on St. Patrick's Day.
I do remember that.
And the head coach, because they were, it was for us, it was 11 o'clock, but for them, it was midnight, and he just points up at the clock. He's like, I don't know if you saw this, but it's midnight now, so it's St. Patrick's Day. This is St. Patrick's Day. That's when it happened. I was like, what a legend. I was like, that is an insane, that's insane reaction in the moment.
Riley, I know you keep bringing up the, how many people are watching us on YouTube?
Let me check.
I would like them to see us, though. I don't think they could see us now. Thank
hey,
you.
Yeah, there I've been go. Terrible with the video stream yeah, so
okay.
far today.
It's okay. Look, Riley, I'm going to be really honest with you. We're allowed to be honest with each other around here.
Yeah.
This hasn't been the most organized show.
No.
That might be my fault. That might be your fault. I think it's definitely Pablo's fault.
It's not my fault.
It's the ADD of Pablo Iglesias' fault.
I just like I to talk. I could see it. Whoa, hey, whoa, Mr. Reliable out here, man. Well, you know what? Hey, this is what happens. Some good teams run into adversity.
Yeah,
you know,
they do.
They have good chemistry, but sometimes they got to get after each other. You know, you can't have a perfect synergy situation.
No.
You just hope it's all happy, you know, la-di-da.
It's not all sunshine and rainbows,
yeah,
Pop.
Man, that's it.
That's so
it's
real.
It's all about life. It's not how many times you get hit. It's about how hard you can get hit.
Okay, Rocky.
No, that's actually a direct quote from me.
Oh, yeah, you made that one
yeah,
up.
Yeah, I just made it just right
Did you just Michael Scott that one? Right? It's Rocky Balboa, Pablo Iglesias.
This is just, yes, right?
Yeah.
Miss 100% of the shots you don't take. Wayne Gretzky.
Michael Scott.
Yes.
Saturday tip-off. Okay.
Who would you be in the office?
Dwight.
You really? You're choosing to be Dwight.
I don't think I just think that's the energy I give
you
off.
You are not Dwight.
My what's John Krasinski's character? I gotta make a confession.
Do you have a crush on John Krasinski?
Well, yes. That's not
I think
my
we
confession.
All do.
Yeah, we all do. That's not my confession. My confession is I haven't watched The Office all the way through. I know that's like a Generation Z sin. You're Gen Z, right?
No, I'm actually a millennial.
Are you?
95.
Oh.
I'm not 95 years old. I was born in... Correction.
I don't think anybody listening to this. It's like, wow,
the dad driving
to
Woodman's.
Ancient. The dad in Woodman's. Yeah, no doubt.
Yeah, we did just lose two viewers on YouTube.
Oh,
so.
No.
Oh, no.
Because they now know I'm not 95. This I just feel like this good. Is what we're just gonna just keep giggling. Like that's what the remainder of this show is. Like we're not even gonna say things now. We've gotten to that point.
Are you celebrating St. Patrick's Day this weekend?
I do believe in St. Patrick's
That's not my question.
You know, it's always fun. Because of our weird schedules, to be totally honest, it's hard. I mean, tomorrow's Selection Sunday, so it's pretty much always been work mode. Honor it, have some corned beef. I
love corned beef.
Yes. So corned beef is always good. Corned beef hash.
Yes.
That is where it's at.
There's a restaurant. No free advertising. There's a restaurant and bar in Middleton. It's very close to the high school.
Yes.
They have great breakfast.
Yes.
They have very good corned beef hash.
Good fish fry, too, I think.
Yes.
I know what
yeah,
you're
we're talking about the same place.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, we are. We are. Good for us. Good for us to be yes. on the same wavelength.
I think my friend won pull tabs, and it was like, he won like $200.
Yeah, $250 probably. That's a jackpot typically on pull tabs.
That's
pull tabs big in Illinois. You grew up in Illinois.
No. That is a Wisconsin. Back at home, my parents are giving the nod of approval that we do in fact do pull tabs. As our other Illinois representatives in here, we do pull tabs in Chicago in Illinois. But I mean, it feels like it's significantly bigger here.
Have you immersed yourself in the pull tab culture of Wisconsin?
I have not. I feel like I'm behind of the dive bar culture. I mean, I go to dive bars, but in terms of pull tabs, still got to get in it.
All right, you and I are hanging out this week.
We got a Wisconsin
culture. Hang out of the century. We'll get back on the rails with the Badgers Sports Talk Radio segment of the century. Coming up next on Saturday Tip-Off, Pablo Iglesias, Alex Stroff with you right here on ESPN Madison.
This is Saturday Tip-Off on ESPN Wisconsin and Wisconsin On Demand. Mike Greenberg.
Green. It's hard to win games multiple years in a row when your leading rusher is your quarterback. Lamar Jackson is uniquely gifted, but even he cannot be expected to just do this year after year. Derrick Henry is a beast. He is one of one. He is a dynamic weapon, and he will help the Ravens get back to that point where they have a chance to get over the hump this time. I love the signing.
Greeny, weekdays noon to 2 on 100.5 ESPN.
Hey, it's Kyle Walls here from ESPN Wisconsin's Kyle Bruston Nortman, and I gotta tell you about one of my new favorite ways to watch games with the Underdog Fantasy Sports app, a pick'em fantasy game where you can win real money. It's easy to find in your app store and even easier to use. Here's how it works. Pick 2 to 5 players from at least 2 different teams, then select higher or lower on those player stats. If your picks hit, you can win up to 100 times your money. Yeah, it is that easy. Especially with the hoop season hitting high gear, you know I'm watching every game with the Underdog Fantasy app. So right now, head to their easy-to-use mobile app or underdogfantasy.com and sign up using promo code KBN. Underdog will match your first deposit up to $100. Plus, they'll give you a mystery special pick to use on your first pick'em entry. That's promo code KBN. Join me and get the Underdog Fantasy app so that you can enhance your game watching experience just like me. Must be 18 plus and present in the state where Underdog Fantasy operates. Terms apply. Concerned with your play? Call 1-800-GAMBLER or visit ncpgambling.org.
We tend not to think about right now, but right now in front of us is victory over cancer. Right now, cancer research funded by the V Foundation is leading to better treatments and saving lives. When you give to the V Foundation, 100% of your donation goes directly to game-changing cancer research. Victory over cancer is there for the taking by you. Donate at V.org, because today's cancer research is tomorrow's victory.
Don't give up. Don't ever give up.
Hey, hungry? And your heart is ticking for chicken? Well, take a quick turn into Quick Trip, because we got
no ordinary chicken.
Yeah, go wild with wings. Next level super wings with trusty Sidekick and sauces. Or let's talk tender. Quick Chick tenders. Love me tenders. Love me some Quick tenders. Ours are bigger, better, tastier. Or if you're feeling good old school comfort fried chicken, we got it. Hand breaded down homier than anywhere. Quick Trip, saving your nuggets from ordinary.
Spring will be here before you know it, and so will Marco Siki's 6th Annual Casting for Kids Fishing Tournament, Saturday, May 18th on the Madison Chain of Lakes. Created to help children who are fighting cancer at American Family Children's Hospital, UW-Carbone Cancer Center. There's a limit of 80 boats for a fun day on the water before 2:30 happy hour at Alliant Energy Center, a silent auction, dinner, and a live auction at 4 o'clock. Help us help the kids. Casting for Kids, Saturday, May 18th. Sign up or donate at castingforkids.org.
Big trailers and big opportunity. Since 1962, Stoughton Trailers has been a family-owned and operated business. With competitive wages and excellent benefits, plus growth and advancement opportunities, Stoughton Trailers is an exciting place to grow your career. Join the collaboration, innovation, and dynamic team atmosphere at Stoughton Trailers. With positions now open in production, operations, finance, sales, engineering, supply chain, and more. Go to stojobs.com to apply today. Stoughton Trailers, big trailers, big opportunity.
To those who've ever dreamt of their perfect event, those dreams are worthy and they are possible. Hi, it's Jeffrey from Celebrations Entertainment. With hard work, passion, and great music, we will make your event dreams a reality. Every event is a labor of love, with one-on-one planning, customization, and flawless execution. Bringing your event to life is what we do. For a fun, memorable event, visit celebrationsentertainment.com. That's celebrationsentertainment.com.
There's a new safety in town.
Xavier McKinney is somebody who is what exactly we're looking for this defense. Talk about needs, talk about fit. This is a great fit for this defense.
Nobody covers the green and gold like 100.5 ESPN.
Lesson of the century.
We're getting a lot over here because I believe in St. Patrick's Day. What about you, Strofe?
I also believe in St. Patrick's Day.
I'm just going to scream louder and louder until we sign off.
Saturday tip-off, Alex Strofe, Pablo Iglesias, Riley Auk with you from the Everlight Solar Studio in downtown Madison on your Saturday morning. What are you playing right now? Is this Sinead O'Connor?
You're right. It is. Oh, see, I forgot how slow.
Go.
I should have got to like the bum bada bada bum bum bada bada bum bum a little faster, but it's a Foggy Dew.
Irish
song.
I actually thought your rendition of it was perfect, right?
Okay, thank you. I thought it was in the same room.
Yeah. Yeah, I thought that was Sinead O'Connor, actually. Yeah.
Close. No doubt about it. The viewers agree. We're up to 8 now.
Wow. Wow.
We're doing it.
People are coming
doubling
through
the
for us
numbers.
Now.
We're doubling the
They still can't see us, though, Riley.
I'm pretty sure they can.
Da, 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 da.
Oh, yeah,
they
you're
can.
Right.
They
All
can.
Right. My bad.
We're
bad.
So back.
Okay. Pablo, we got you for about 6 more minutes.
All right.
Because you have to go work.
Let's just giggle for these next 6 minutes. Anyway.
I want to wrap up quick. We'll be joined next segment, or I'll be joined, rather, next segment is Pablo and company, his parents, who have graciously listened to us for the last hour and a half. We appreciate your support.
This has been a fun journey.
I think your dad's sitting over there like, wow, these guys are idiots. Like, he's just shaking his head. What the hell have I gotten myself into this morning? You're lucky he loves you.
You guys love me, right? I get a thumbs up.
Your dad he waited a few seconds, but then he gave the thumbs up. He thought about it real hard. But before we let you go, I do want to wrap up with the Badgers because, as we mentioned a bit earlier, if you're just joining us, Badgers playing in the Big Ten tournament semifinals today, about an hour and a half from right now on CBS against Purdue. winner obviously going to tomorrow's Big Ten championship game. It's a team that seemingly has figured it out over the course of the last week. They were a team that was viewed as a top 10 team in the country in January. February was atrocious. No other way to spell it out, right? It was a really, really, really bad month of February. They fell from the AP poll, obviously, when they were number six to begin the month. 2 weeks ago was the first time all season in the AP poll they didn't receive a single vote. And now they've whooped Maryland. They beat up on Northwestern yesterday, and they have the opportunity to beat Purdue today in the Big Ten tournament semifinals. Now, you said earlier, Purdue seemingly wins the Big Ten tournament every year, and then they lose in the NCAA tournament. But Wisconsin has lost to Purdue twice. It's hard to beat a team three times in a season. If Stephen Crowell can score double digits, I think they win today.
I think so. And I'm just looking at Purdue's situation here, too. I believe, if I'm correct, since their Rutgers win, which was 96-68 a few weeks ago, they haven't won a game by double digits since. So, I mean, and let's talk about this, too, with Michigan State. That was a team that had them, you know, kind of on the ropes there. Tom Izzo, too. I don't know if you saw this this other interview or this interview yesterday where he didn't call out the refereeing
on a
TV interview. I'll show it to you later. But pretty much saying he's like that he didn't like the calls and just had to go back to the bench. But anyway, it's a strong Purdue team, but anybody is vulnerable at this time of the year. It's truly what it is, and I think especially from a neutral site standpoint, anything's possible. On the flip side, yes, Purdue early in the season beat a good Marquette team. And I believe Arizona too in the Maui Gym tournament. They have proven that, you know, the neutral floor site, you know, isn't necessarily like a tough thing for them. But I still think it's a little interesting. I like the way that the Badgers are trending. My thing is if you look at the starting five, if Chucky Hepburn's back too, that's going to be great. He's not the guy that we see taking the shots the last few years. He's more of becoming kind of the point guard to share the wealth. He'll take shots when he needs to. I want to see AJ Storr go off like he did yesterday. He was a monster. I mean, he's got a solid jumper, but when Stephen Crowell, of course, he's got to be a beast in the paint. He's going to have his hands full with Zach Edey, and it's going to be interesting watching how is that help defense, because that's what you have to do against Zach Edey. But that help defense is going to be interesting in terms of going to Zach Edey or sticking to the guy on the wing and what's going to happen from there. But if AJ Storr can remain aggressive, keep driving to the bucket, not settle for jump shots, because that's where things get a little, you know, murky. Just keep attacking the paint, get to the line as much as you can, because I think that's the big thing for AJ Storr. He was a beast yesterday.
I can't believe the switch you just flipped in a matter of like 30 seconds. You went from yelling about how you believe about St. Patrick's Day to giving very in-depth analysis on Purdue, Wisconsin today. You're a pro, dude.
What can I say?
He's a pro. He's Pablo Iglesias from WKOW. You can get him on Twitter at Pablo Iglesias TV to follow along all of his shenanigans. He'll be back on ESPN Madison coming up on Monday from 4 to 6 p.m. Afternoon drive time, Pop.
Let's do it. You know, the nice thing, too, is that I remember I brought a fake mustache because anytime I'd fill in on Rutledge and Hamilton, I didn't have my facial hair.
You have facial hair
now. I have facial hair. For everybody listening, too, I do have facial hair now. So not watching, listening. You know, you can listen to my facial hair on Monday. I don't know what. See, this is where it's just going from one thing to the next. But no, it's always funny.
You're good at this radio thing.
Yeah.
Pop.
Hey, what
proud
can I say? Hey, thank you. That's what I was looking for. Though.
I'm proud of you.
Yeah. I wanted that from you.
When you walk out of here, let me know if your dad says that to you, because I think he might be disappointed.
this is cooked.
After what he's watched for the last hour, 45.
Did we get the around the horn, Riley? Were you keeping track of the points here?
Just make them up. I don't think it was
just
close.
Just go for it.
Who? No, but if I was keeping track, I think the final score would have been Pablo 57, Strofe 3.
It's like Larry Bird at the three-point contest. I didn't even have to wait for the results. I knew it was going in.
57-3. All right, Pablo, you got to go do real work. So appreciate you coming in this morning. Looking forward to seeing you on Monday on Rutledge and Hamilton.
It's been fun. Thanks, guys.
At Pablo Iglesias TV on Twitter if you want to follow along with Pablo. Jesse Nelson will join me from the Kohl Center coming up next as we get you set for Zimbraconda's presentation of Prep Mania. All five state championship games coming up on 100.5 ESPN later today. Jesse Nelson joins me next right here on ESPN Madison.
This is Saturday Tip-Off on ESPN Wisconsin and Wisconsin On Demand.
Hi, this is Scott Trout of Cordell & Cordell. There are a lot of great dads out there. Sometimes those dads get divorced.
For more than 30 years, we have represented men in divorce, confronting the pitfalls that could devastate your finances or harm your family relationships. While every situation is different, our goal is to get the best outcome for you and your kids. Visit CordellCordell.com to take the first step.
Schedule an appointment with one of Cordell & Cordell's Madison area attorneys. 1110 Fourier Drive, Suite 120, Madison, Wisconsin, 53717.
Do you hear that? Asthma triggers are everywhere, from dust mites, pet dander, and pollen, to smog and smoke. An asthma attack can strike anywhere, anytime. Be prepared with quick-acting Primatene Mist. Clinically proven to open airways quickly. It's the number one FDA-approved asthma inhaler available over-the-counter. Primatene Mist. Breathe easy again. Use as directed.
What is a better buying experience? Well, you're minutes away from a better buying experience at Simden Chevy in Mount Horeb. Jim Rutledge here. To me, a better buying experience is a personal experience. That's what Dan and his sales team have set up at Simden Chevy in Mount Horeb. You're going to have the experience that you're looking for. You're going to define what that better buying experience is for you, and they're going to get you in the vehicle that you need and that you want, whether it's new or new to you. So when you're looking for a better buying experience, go to Simden Chevy in Mount Horeb.
Get the beat of the Bucks straight from a fan favorite and Bucks legend. Tap into Hear District with Marcus Johnson, a Bucks Plus audio production. Your weekly pulse on the Milwaukee Bucks and conversations with the biggest names in basketball. This week, Marcus and his son Chris are joined by ESPN NBA writer Jamal Collier.
People shouldn't overlook that because he has been consistently dominant every single night.
Find Hear District now on Bucks.com/plus, the Bucks app, or wherever you get your podcast.
At Gruber Law Offices, we take great pride in helping those who have trusted us after a serious accident. Our team has the knowledge, resources, and experience to get you the results you deserve. Don't wait to get the help you need. Make the right call. Call Gruber Law Offices today, proud partner of Wisconsin Athletics. One call, that's all.
Hey, it's Bobby Portis, and I love playing basketball in Milwaukee. When I drive down the lane, I move fast and make sudden moves to drive to the hoop and score. But when I'm behind the wheel in the driving lane, I control my drive. I don't speed or make sudden movements. Speeding and reckless driving are the leading causes of traffic injuries and deaths in Wisconsin. Do what I do. Control your drive. Don't speed. Don't be reckless. Zero in, Wisconsin. Together we can save lives. Wisconsin DOT.
From the biggest plays on the court to the comments made in the locker room after, an in-depth recap of every Bucks game in 6 minutes. No more, no less. Bucks in Six provides game recaps for every game. Hear the high-flying dunks from Giannis.
Puts it on the floor, spins down the lane, and plunges it through.
Or the deep threes from Dame.
Dame time has arrived with 107.
Bucks in Six on the Bucks Plus Audio Network. Find it now on Bucks.com/plus or on Spotify, Apple, and wherever you get your podcasts.
Hey, it's Hunter Vaughn. ESPN Madison and Zimbrick Honda are celebrating the area's best high school sports stories with the Game Changers of the Month. Follow ESPN Madison on social media to see teams making an impact in their community. Nominate your local team today at ESPNMadisonGameChangers.com.
Like, share, and follow ESPN Madison everywhere. Follow us on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok for more great content from ESPN Madison. This is 100.5 ESPN and Wisconsin On Demand.
Tip-off, right, wrapping it up as we lead you into Zimbrick Honda's presentation of Prep Mania. All five WIAA Boys Basketball State Championships will be heard right here on 100.5 ESPN today. We got a text from Nate in Stoughton on the text line, 844-770-3776, that says, "Is this show on every Saturday? It's already my second favorite." I don't know what his first favorite is. But yeah, we could do this every Saturday. Riley, you want to do this every Saturday?
Yeah, why not? I'm down.
Well, the guy that makes that decision joins us now from the Kohl Center.
What?
ESPN Madison content manager Jesse Nelson. Wonderful play-by-play voices as well. Getting ready for the Division 5 state championship game coming up at the top of the hour. Jesse Nelson joins us now from the Kohl Center. Jesse, can we do this every Saturday?
Pablo is welcome every Saturday to the ESPN Madison airwaves.
What does that mean for Riley?
What does it mean for you, Strofe?
We'll get to me.
What does it mean for anyone?
Pablo is welcome anytime he wants to join. On a Saturday morning, 9 to 11, absolutely, we'll make it happen. The pieces around him, you know, it's kind of, you got to choose who your franchise players are. And I think we found a franchise player. We found a cleanup hitter here in Poly, Mr. Do-It-All, Five Tool. And I don't know if we've got that from the rest of the crew yet. We'll have to probably do a little more analysis of the tape. I might have to actually listen a little more intently than I have so far this morning and see what we got here. But
wow, what a great program director, Riley, huh? Yeah, I got to listen more.
I think you would have been very impressed, Jesse.
Hey, first of all, when I'm sitting next to the great Adam Mertz at the Kohl Center getting ready to call a Division 5 state championship game, I got other priorities in place here, fellas.
Is Mertz on a headset?
He's right here.
I think he's good.
Mertz? Absolutely.
Okay, why did nobody tell me that? I wouldn't want to talk to Jesse then. I would have wanted to talk to Mertz.
I mean,
that's not me.
You want to talk about who's going to be hosting this Saturday show. Mertz's putting in the work here too, Strofe.
Adam Mertz joins us as well here on a special edition of Saturday Tip-Off. And I the thing I love about Mertz is I could literally go anywhere with him and he will have insight. He's the smartest man in the Madison area. Mertz, Badgers Purdue today. How do you feel about Wisconsin's chances against Zach Edey and company?
Well, I mean, thank you very much for the compliments.
The smartest man in Madison.
That's kind of a high bar. I mean, I feel like I'm going to disappoint whatever analysis I deliver at this point.
He's smart. Smartest man in Madison.
There's like physicists. There's like physicists.
There's an entire college.
I live here.
Multiple colleges, actually. So your question about Zach Edey and Purdue. Hey, you know what? You know, am I optimistic? No, but Badgers are coming into this thing with absolutely nothing to lose, and you love that. You absolutely love that when you can go in and just play out. So I don't buy the whole third time's charm and all that kind of stuff, but they know what they need to do. It's a matter of if they're hitting or not.
I would agree with that, as we saw them do the other night against Maryland. 64% from outside. Mercy, if we gave you 103-point shots on the Kohl Center right in front of you, 103-point shots, how many are you making?
Wide open with no crowd.
Correct.
And no
like three-point contest style.
I mean, at least 23.
Okay, 23. Jesse, how many are you making?
Three.
Riley?
And I'm calling bank on at least one of them.
Yeah, that's fair. Riley?
100 shots?
100 shots.
I think I can make 35 to 40.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
You think you're a 40% three-point shooter?
Yeah, 100 shots?
People say I have ridiculous confidence.
Wait, 40%? What's Strofe's
number? Why not?
Riley, what kind of basketball experience do you have?
I played CYO in high school. I just finished
CYO? That's intramural.
Yeah, that's great. I went on a two-minute tear in seventh grade at the end of a game. Like, that doesn't mean I'm going to be any good.
We just lost our IM finals in fifth overtime. I had one
three-pointer. Wait a minute. You outdid Arrowhead and Nina?
We did.
Where has this been for the last 2 hours? This is why Pablo gets the show and you don't.
Spent an entire segment on a four overtime game and you didn't mention that?
I thought about it, but I didn't think it was relevant. Now we're talking about my basketball experience, so it's relevant.
It's never been more relevant, Riley.
We are talking about the longest running high school basketball game in the 108-year history of the Wisconsin State Tournament that went to four overtimes. You played in a game this week that went to five overtimes, and you didn't think that was relevant.
Yeah, but it was in college, so it's not high school. Our overtime was 1 minute long.
I'm going to have an aneurysm. How did you miss this?
It's on me.
All right, Jesse, I'm starting to understand your take. I don't know if Riley's welcome. Mertzy, what's your basketball experience that you're shooting 25? By the way, to answer your question, I'm hitting like 11. I'm doing more than Jesse, but less than you.
I was an excellent bench warmer for a team that once won four varsity games in one season. Wow. However, I did score 15 in an intramural game at UW once.
Wow.
Only overtimes. No overtime. No straight regulation.
You guys are getting set for the Division 5 state championship game, which kicks off our coverage all day long right here on 100.5 ESPN. Zimbraconda's presentation of Prep Mania. Mertzi, Division 5. What do we need to know from Mertzi? What's Mertzi's point of view on this game, Division 5 state title game?
Well, I mean, I think this is a really exciting, obviously coming from the Madison market here, an exciting day for Abundant Life for that school. They had never won a regional title before, let alone thinking about going to the state tournament. That's an unbelievable run. And I've seen this before about how programs, you know, you can't get over the hump until you've had that experience, and they've just blistered straight through that. So I'm excited to see them. And then obviously the incredible shooters from Marshfield Columbus Catholic dropped 13 yesterday, and as Jesse was reminding me, 14 trays in the sectional final. So these guys are really fun to watch, both really like skilled and disciplined teams, and you don't see that all the time at Division 5.
Our coverage starts in just a few minutes from the Kohl Center. Zimbraconda's presentation of Prep Mania. Those two goofballs, Jesse Nelson, Adam Mertz, have you covered for the Division 5 state title game. Thanks, fellas.
Looking forward to championship Saturday. Thanks, guys. Appreciate it.
Looking forward to championship Saturday as well. All five can be heard right here on 100.5 ESPN, as well as our sister station. If you're driving north, flip over to the AM dial. 1430 ESPN Beaver Dam has you covered as well. And as always, you can stream those games for free. The ESPN app, the Wisconsin On Demand app. Just tell your smart speaker, hey, Alexa, play ESPN Madison statewide. All five state champions crowned right here today. Big thanks to Riley Yauch. Big thanks to Pablo Iglesias. Big thanks to Mr. and Mrs. Iglesias, our live studio audience.
For real.
For joining us here on Saturday tip-off. Coming up next, Zimbraconda's championship presentation of Prep Mania. I'm Alex Stroff. This has been Saturday tip-off.
Hey, it's Kyle Walls here from ESPN Wisconsin's Kyle Bruston-Nortman, and I gotta tell you about one of my new favorite ways to watch games with the Underdog Fantasy Sports app, a pick'em fantasy game where you can win real money. It's easy to find in your app store and even easier to use. Here's how it works. Pick 2 to 5 players from at least 2 different teams, then select higher or lower on those player stats. If your picks hit, you can win up to 100 times your money. Yeah, it is that easy. Especially with the hoop season hitting high gear, you know I'm watching every game with the Underdog Fantasy app. So right now, head to their easy-to-use mobile app or underdogfantasy.com and sign up using promo code KBN. Underdog will match your first deposit up to $100. Plus, they'll give you a mystery special pick to use on your first pick'em entry. That's promo code KBN. Join me and get the Underdog Fantasy app so that you can enhance your game watching experience just like me. Must be 18 plus and present in the state where Underdog Fantasy operates. Terms apply. Concerned with your play? Call 1-800-GAMBLER or visit ncpgambling.org.
Greg Scalzo here for Buck and Honey's. Congratulations to the perennial Best of Madison Award winner by the folks at Madison Magazine. Meet me at Buck and Honey's to celebrate Wisconsin hospitality. Whether you're enjoying the view on the Yahara River in Monona, exploring Wanakee, visiting the OG in Sun Prairie, or checking out the new location in Mount Horeb, you can enjoy the Buck and Honey's experience in a neighborhood.